Championship. That's Monday night, 6 o'clock on Sports Night.
The number two ranked Panthers and Big East Player of the Year candidate Aaron Gray are looking to go a perfect 8-0. It's Pittsburgh and Auburn on CSS. From Beard Eve Memorial Coliseum on the campus of Auburn University, we're set for college basketball. Hello, everyone. I'm Paul Ellen, set to bring you the play-by-play this afternoon as the Pittsburgh Panthers take it on the road for the first time against the Auburn University Tigers. The Pitt Panthers are undefeated thus far this season. They have climbed all the way up to number two in the polls behind UCLA. They are a team set for a long run in the NCAAs this season, coached by Jamie Dixon. Alongside me today, Sonny Smith. And Sonny, this is a well-constructed Pittsburgh Panther team.
Well, they're a great defensive ball club to start with. They're very versatile. They can go nine deep, and those nine people can score, and they control the tempo of the game. That's what they're the best at.
Now, this Auburn team, still a young team, but much more experienced than the team that went up to Pittsburgh last year and kind of had their hats handed to them.
Well, there's more experience on this ball club, and there's also more speed. They're a little bit stronger, and Kovartney Barber's playing awfully well on the inside. So I think this is a club that's going to get better and better when they get all their club together.
A lot of NBA scouts are on hand this afternoon in Auburn, Alabama, and they're on hand to see one guy. That is 7-foot center Aaron Gray. Sonny, Aaron Gray is a big-time player.
Well, he's improved every year. He's lost weight. He can step away from the basket 12 feet and knock down shots. He's a great shooter. His inside presence makes him a better player. He's capable of a double-double every night.
And for the Auburn Tigers, the biggest signee of the Jeff Lebo era so far has been Kovartney Barber. He's a sophomore now. He's put on weight, and he has taken this team on his shoulders thus far this year.
Well, I think the key word is put on weight. He's bulked up. He's now getting double-doubles. He improves those free throws. He's going to be a solid player. He's a better defender. A lot is expected of Kovartney, and I think he will do it this year.
The Auburn Tigers trying to keep their home winning streak alive. The Pittsburgh Panthers are trying to stay undefeated. When we come back, we'll be back with the tip. It's Pittsburgh against Auburn from Auburn, Alabama.
Hey, look, there goes another one.
I can see that.
What do all those white trucks do anyway?
Well, they're not selling ice cream.
Oh, too bad. I could really go for a fudge bomb.
They're out here to make sure the juice keeps flowing.
Juice? Like the stuff from an orange?
No. Juice like the stuff that makes things run.
Where is all this juice?
It's flowing through these wires.
Just goes on and on? No beginning? No end?
Yep. Kind of like this conversation.
Let's talk about computerized phone numbers. Let's talk about being stuck on hold for 20 minutes. Let's talk about forgetting all of that. Let's talk about a real person that picks up the phone and knows you by name. Let's talk about a relationship.
Choosing a team to decorate your home isn't easy. You drive one place to get your floor covering, another place to find your living room, and another to find a bedroom. Wouldn't it be nice to discover one place where you can find everything you need for your home? Then discover our team at the Carpets of Dalton American Home Showplace Campus. From the floor to the ceiling, from the home office to the bedroom, from the kitchen to the patio, the campus can help you make an educated decision on getting the best value for your money. Discover the most unique home shopping experience you've ever seen. One-stop shopping from a team that cares.
SEC Men's Basketball on CSS is presented by the Cochran Firm. We're at Beard Eve Memorial Coliseum on the campus of Auburn University. Paul Ellen along with Sonny Smith back with you here as we get set for the tip-off between the number two rated Pittsburgh Panthers and the Auburn University Tigers. The Pittsburgh Panthers, as we said, find the number two in the country. Levon Kendall and Mike Cook, the forwards. The big All-America candidate, Aaron Gray in the middle. And LaVance Fields and Antonio Graves handle the ball on the outside. They are nine deep. For the Auburn Tigers, still a young team, but an experienced team. They are led by forward Corvodny Barber. Josh Dollard getting his first start of the season tonight as well. And the three-guard lineup anchored by Rasheem Barrett, Quantez Robertson, and Frank Talbert. You see the lights are down here at Beardy's Memorial Coliseum as the Auburn team being introduced here. Pittsburgh, the second highest rated non-conference team to play here. 1969 was the last time a higher rated team came in a non-conference game. That was the University of South Carolina, rated number one at the time. Pittsburgh going on the road for the first time this year. They are 7-0, all home games thus far, one neutral site game played at West Point to open the season. The lights come up and they're revved up here at Beardy's Memorial Coliseum. The Auburn Tigers, coached by Jeff Lebo in his third year at the helm of the Tigers. He is building a young program here, the former All-America point guard for North Carolina, and you see his record there in his third year at Auburn. Jamie Dixon, the coach of the Pittsburgh Panthers. Dixon in his fourth year at the helm. He was 4 years as an assistant, so eight consecutive years he has been coaching the Pittsburgh Panthers, and he has built quite a program. Series history, of course, Pitt won last year, and that was the only meeting between the two teams as the Panthers got out early at home and just demolished Auburn in a one-sided victory. Auburn a year older, hoping to do much better. A veteran officiating crew today, Tim Higgins, Jim Burr, Bob Donato. Of course, Higgins and Burr have been around for quite some time. They are out of the Big East, but they call games all up and down the Eastern Seaboard, and we are set to get things underway as Auburn in white. And Bot Barber controls the tip for the Tigers, so Auburn will go on offense first, and we're underway.
Pittsburgh will be playing man-for-man, a very solid, team-oriented man-for-man defense.
Auburn tries to penetrate and can't. That is Josh Dollard, the big power forward, out handling the ball. Gets it back away to Robertson, trying to drive. He dishes to Barber, and Barber dunks and draws the foul. Well, Sonny, that's a good start for these Auburn Tigers.
Paul, that's called penetrate and drop. Draw a defender to you and drop. A great drive to the bucket using the left hand. Tremendous vision. Drops it off to Vaught, and he slams it home.
Foul goes against Cook. First foul on Mike Cook and the first team foul on the Panthers. And Barber will go to the free throw line, and that's an area where Auburn has struggled this year, Sonny.
Yeah, Corvodny is McDonald's All-American. One thing that has messed his game up a little bit is this free throw line. They say he's getting better, and that's a good-looking stroke and evidence of him getting better right there.
Auburn going to apply a little backcourt pressure to start things off.
Paul, this is to speed up the game. They want to make these guys play a little quicker. They want to control the tempo, and this defense, this 1-3-1 half-court trap, full-court press will help.
Pittsburgh, a very deep team, but they don't like to run. There's Cook, the transfer from East Carolina, missing with a three, and Talbert is there to clear for Auburn.
A very important factor here is the rebounding ability of Auburn.
Dollard with a quick shot off the rim, and Pitt is out running now. That's Antonio Graves and Graves.
Graves is an outstanding three-point shooter. His average has not been as high as they expected to be. It's 45%, and that is really good.
We're testing to see if this is a two or a three, and it looked to be a three. The officials are going to look and see if that right toe was on the line, and so we have a momentary stoppage in play. And Gray, a very good spot-up shooter, and Sonny, that's one thing about this Pittsburgh team. They would like to play half-court if possible on both ends of the floor. They want to play that just face-up man-to-man, but they also very good step-up shooters.
I do not believe his foot was on the line. I think there's evidence of being a three. And he is an outstanding three-point shooter. Nope, I'm not so sure about that. On second thought.
And it's going to be a two.
On second thought. Well, you never question officials, especially when I'm questioning them.
And you've never questioned him, certainly.
Never in my life. Never in my life.
So it's a two-point goal to get Pittsburgh on the board here. We're 1 minute in. Auburn leading by one, and the Tigers bring it up.
This will be a real test for Quantez Robertson.
Talbert drives and scores.
I love this man's game. I love his inside presence. I love his outside presence. His effort. He cuts down on his turnovers. He can be a heck of a player.
Talbert is high energy for Auburn. There's Kendall trying to move with the ball. And is guarded tightly on the baseline sideline
And the ball knocked out of bounds. It'll go back to the Panthers.
Well, they're going to double team the ball when it goes to the wing. That's and they're going to front the post. So they're going to try to keep the ball out of the post, put pressure on the wings with double ups.
Mike Cook has been a big factor for Pitt so far this year, the transfer from East Carolina. Their number two scorer, but he has passed the ball very well.
Auburn in a 1-3-1 zone, a zone that's been very good to them.
They're staying in that zone. It's tipped and stolen. Out on the run is Talbert. Talbert goes in and throws it away almost, but it's saved by Dollard, and Dollard lays it up and in.
Dollard looks like he's bulked up and looking stronger than a year ago, and Auburn off to a good start.
Kendall down quickly. They pass up the shot, but there's Cook driving. Tipped by Graves, and there's Talbert to clear.
Auburn on the run, trying to make the tempo up.
There's Barber. Barber draws another foul, lays it in, and that's going to be the first on Gray. Right now, Sonny, Auburn able to run, and if the Tigers can continue to run, they will do well in this game.
You're going to see Quantes Robinson always with his head up. Beautiful pass inside. Use of the feet very well by Kravotny Barber to knock down the layup.
Barber with 5 quick points. And he misses the free throw, and it comes off long. And Pitt will clear. That'll be Fields. Fields gets it down very quickly. Now Pitt will set up in that half-court offense.
Pitt will run with makes and with misses, and they'll run with long rebounds.
Good hands by Gray. Gets it away to Graves, and Graves hits the three.
Now the 1-3-1 zone on the perimeter must get out and get Antonio Graves, because he is an outstanding three-point shooter, shooting 45% from that area, and that is great.
Auburn with an early four-point lead. Now the Tigers will turn it over there. Extra step outside by Rasheem Barrett trying to penetrate.
Auburn has been outstanding with this 1-3-1 zone this year. They can extend it into a three-quarter court trap. They can do it at half court, and they do a tremendous job of causing you to have to play quicker than you want to.
Fields thought about the shot. Now he gets it away to Cook. And Cook with a baseline jumper, and he's on the board as well.
Well, the East Carolina transfer is outstanding on two-point jump shots from 12 to 15 feet. He also can knock down the three. He's a great addition to this ball club, and he's also very unselfish.
Gray comes out to pick up the point guard. He retreats inside. Three on the way, rattles out. Ball stolen inside by Talbert, tied up. And they're going to say Talbert was on the baseline. Well, you're right about instant energy. Talbert is bringing some energy to the early moments of this game, Sonny.
Well, I don't think anybody's going to play any harder than Frank Talbert. He cuts down on his turnovers. He comes instantly one of the better players in the Southeastern Conference. And you're also playing a team that, as far as physicality, there's nobody any better. Picked to win the Big East, and they are, as you see, a charge committed by Mike Cook, and I believe that might be his second foul.
That is his second. Third team foul. It'll be a turnover on Pitt. Auburn showed man-to-man pressing in backcourt, immediately doubled when the ball went out on the wing, and able to draw the foul, could not expect him to double, and now we're going to get a substitution.
Well, they're going to do that out of this 1-3-1. They can loose trap you by getting away from you, or they can tight trap you. Right now they're tight trapping, and it's been very, very effective.
Sam Young has checked in, replacing Cook for the Panthers. There's Dollard. Dollard's going to try another three. He's long in the rebound. Off to the smallest man on the floor, LaVance Fields.
Well, he's a very good point guard. He's strong, and he does share the basketball.
Didn't take Young long to track a shot up there. Dollard clears. Dollard getting his first start of the season for Auburn, and he adds some bulk to that Auburn lineup.
Pittsburgh getting back on transition defense, doing a good job in that area, especially after a defensive rebound.
Talbert handles out front. Gray knocks it away and steals. And then there's a cheap foul on Kravotny Barber. And you know Jeff Lebo doesn't want to see that.
That's the first foul on Kravotny. And he's a guy that needs to stay in a game. Experience. He is getting better. He's had double-doubles this year. That's something Auburn players have not seen very much of recently.
Auburn showing man-to-man once again as Pitt comes up in the half court. There's Gray on the baseline, drives, has a shot blocked by Dollard. Gray backs in again, has a shot blocked again by Dollard, and then a foul call. Couple of blocks by Josh Dollard, making his presence felt inside. And let's check the Auburn foul.
I think it's going to be on Talbert. I'm not sure. They've made the show yet.
Auburn will pick up the foul. Aaron Gray will be at the free throw line when we come back. Auburn with the early run in this game in Auburn, Alabama.
At Anders, we do it for our awesome fans. Whether it's fanciful or fanatical, it's all fantastic at Anders. Spirit gear, books, diploma frames, supplies, and more. Anders, now that's the spirit.
Come see our newly renovated store or visit online.
The bear climbed over the mountain, the bear climbed over the mountain, the bear climbed over the mountain, and what do you think he saw? What do you think he saw? What do you think he saw? The bear climbed over the mountain, the bear climbed over the mountain, the bear climbed over the mountain, and what do you think he saw?
Get all the college hoops you can handle with the ESPN Full Court Pay-Per-View Package, presented by Olivia High Definition Television. Up to 450 games, top conferences, critical matchups you won't get in your area. The most complete college basketball pay-per-view package anywhere. Hoops heaven is only a phone call or click away. The ball's in your court. Order now. To order the ESPN Full Court Pay-Per-View Package, call your local cable company or satellite provider.
The Auburn Tigers lead it 9-7. An early run fueled by Corvatny Barber has that lead. As we get set for a return to basketball here at Beard East Memorial Coliseum in Auburn, Alabama. Who's going bowling and who's staying home? Check the final. Talking football of the season for all the latest college gridiron news tonight at 8 o'clock on CSS, your source for Southeast sports.
That's a great show, Paul, to watch football. They right on top of things. Matt Coulter, Tony Barnhart, and all the guys are good.
And they're going to start a basketball show, I understand, right after that. A couple of unknown hosts on that show.
They're going to take a flyer on two guys.
Aaron Gray, the All-America candidate at the line, knocks the first one down to make it a one-point game. And he is on the board.
He went from most improved player in the Big East to the All-American candidate on everybody's ballot, and he's the reason that's full of pro scouts here today. Aaron Gray playing very well. Got a great touch, very unselfish kid, outstanding rebounder, good footwork.
Nice pass inside by Dollard. Barber lays it up and in, and Karvadny Barber with 7 quick points. For the Auburn Tigers, they lead 11-9.
Here's a young man that they need to look to more, and he's feeling it, and he's doing a good job. The 1-3-1, showing 1-3-1, going back to man for man.
Jeff Lebo mixing up his defenses here. Pitt handles it, and there's Kendall with a shot. The rebound tipped out of bounds off the hands of Barrett.
Now, you want somebody to do the dirty work for you. LaVon Kendall does everything for his team. Loose balls, rebounds, runs the offense, very unselfish, an outstanding basketball player.
Waiting the inbounds ball, and it's tipped, but Gray is there to grab it for Pitt and save it. And the Panthers set up in the half court. There's Fields for three. Off the rim, no good, but the rebound cleared by Kendall. And again, he's working that baseline. Here's Graves for three, and he knocks it down.
Now, there's a guy you cannot leave open. Just an outstanding shooter. Antonio Graves from Mansfield, Ohio.
8 points already for Antonio Graves. That's his second three, and the Panthers have their first lead of the game. Dollard working out front, the big power forward for Auburn, trying to draw Gray out there. There's Barrett away to Barber. Barber has a shot blocked and knocked away, but Auburn claims it back. There's Talbert driving back outside to Robertson for three. The rebound comes off long and is grabbed inside by Talbert once again.
Good offensive rebounding by the Tigers.
Talbert with very quick hands. Talbert trying to work it low to Barber. Barber drives and is called for steps before he can knock the shot down. We're going to have wholesale substitution. For the Panthers, coming in will be Tyrell Biggs.
Well, Ramon is in the game.
Ronald
Here's another
Ramon
guy
and Keith Benjamin all in the game now.
Both those guys, Ramon and Benjamin, both can shoot the outside jumper. They can shoot the three ball for you. And a key for Auburn right now is take away these threes from Grave and also to keep banging the boards. Rebounding is going to be a big, big factor. 2 for 4 on threes for the Pittsburgh.
Ramon, number four, handling the ball. He's instant offense for the Panthers. By far, their best three-point shooter, hitting 57% from outside the arc. And he's going to shoot one now, and that 57% just went up.
Well, you know, that's great coaching. Off the bench, in the game, hole, but they set up the first shot for Ronald Ramon, who's an outstanding 57%. That's unheard of.
Inside pass, Barber slams it home, and that's a nice look by Josh Dollard to get the ball to Corvotney Barber.
Well, you got to love the way Josh Dollard is. Having been out for a while, back now, starting to get a feel for the game, moving the basketball. Beautiful pass by Josh.
Panthers by three. Young tries to drive, ball knocked loose, knocked free, loose on the floor, and there's that man again. Talbert claims it for Auburn. Talbert going to shoot the baseline jumper and knock it down. He wanted to come back outside with the ball, but he knocked it away, Sonny. So he said, well, I'm here. I'm going to shoot it up.
All of this created by outstanding half-court defense and full-court pressure for the Tigers.
Jamie Dixon's seen enough. He wants a timeout, and the Panthers will get a quick timeout. It'll be a 30-second timeout.
Well, I tell you now, what you're going to see right now is some beautiful passing, a good post play, a little bit of a walk called on that, and the bump created the walk, but they're not going to call that. And this is a beautiful play by Frank Talbert.
Talbert handling the loose ball, found himself in great position to shoot. He has 4 points, two quick baskets.
Well, if you love the game of basketball, you come and you watch Frank Talbert play, you're going to see as great an effort as you're going to see any place. And if he can just cut down on those turnovers, because his will to win is unbelievable. And talking about effort, Paul, you look at this Pittsburgh team, you're going to find five guys that really get after you and play great team defense, very, very physical. And I can see why they're picked to win the Big East, and they're number two in the country.
Absolutely.
If you let them make those outside shots, they're good.
Tonight's game between Pittsburgh and Auburn is presented by the Cochran Firm. And we're tied after the quick Auburn run. Ramon brings it up against pressure by Auburn, and Auburn dropping back into that 1-3-1. They're going to call a palm on Antonio Graves. Well, you can tell that Tim Higgins is an old-school official. They don't call palming anymore.
Well, they do.
He called it there.
This year, Paul, it's a point of emphasis. If you turn the ball over and gain any kind of advantage out of it, it's going to be called, and that's a good call.
Substitution for Auburn, Dwayne Reed is in the game. Reed, new point guard, and Quintez Robertson stays in the game with Reed in the game, meaning Robertson basically plays 40 minutes. He's going to play wing with Reed at point. There's Robertson driving, can't get it in, but slammed home by Dollard, and Dollard giving Auburn a lot of energy in the early going, getting his first start of the year.
Doing a tremendous job inside, outside, passing the ball, hitting the backboard, playing defense, doing a good job of adjusting the top of the press.
Robertson going to catch a foul there, third team foul on Auburn.
There's an outstanding drive to the basket by Quintez, followed up by Josh Dollard on a rebound. Look at the drive, and the uses body did not foul. Beautiful.
Once he got Pitt committed to the block, nice backdoor rebound by Dollard. Panthers out. Baseline drive up and in by Tyrell Biggs.
Tyrell Biggs, a guy that's lost 20 pounds and getting better every time out.
Tied again at 17. Auburn trying to move the ball. There goes the freshman Reed. Reed gets it out to Robertson, and Robertson in a world of trouble right now, but he gets it away. And there is the long shot by Barrett, no good, and the rebound cleared by the Panthers.
Great job of getting a physical rebound by Sam Young.
Inside it goes to Gray, shot is blocked. Dollard clears for a moment, and it goes out of bounds off the leg, apparently, of Kendall inside.
We have a timeout on the floor.
Timeout on the floor. Nice run by each team, and we're tied midway through the first half here in Auburn, Alabama.
Auburn Bank has been serving East Alabama since 1907. I've had the pleasure of serving the people of Opelika for over 15 years. In that time, I've enjoyed getting to know our customers.
Over the last 25 years, I've enjoyed helping people in the Auburn-Opelika area reach their financial goals. I've also had the opportunity to develop lasting relationships with many of my customers.
Local people serving local needs. That's Auburn Bank.
Auburn Bank, your partner, your neighbor, your friend.
Hi, I'm Tommy Tuberville, head coach of the Auburn Tigers. I wanted to take a minute to tell you about the quality and great taste of Brine Foods. I was really excited when Brian became an official sponsor of Auburn Athletics. My family and I have been enjoying Brian Juicy Jumbos, Tenderloins, and Lunch Meat for years. Auburn fans everywhere should be enjoying what I discovered long ago. Whether on game day or at home, anytime is Brian time.
Next time, use FedEx.
We are tied at 17, Pittsburgh and Auburn here at Beard Eves Coliseum on the Auburn University campus. And Sonny, those Auburn points not coming where you might have expected them to in the first half.
14-0 in the paint by Auburn. You would think it would be the other way, but it's created by penetrate and drop off, or penetrate and rebound and stick back, something that you would think that Pittsburgh would be doing. Right now, Gray is not seeing the basketball, and I can bet you coming out of this timeout, you're going to find that the Panthers are going to start looking inside. The points in the paint, that's incredible, and that's all created by good guard play by Auburn and dropping off and getting some good looks at the basket.
A very surprising stat, and Pittsburgh going small relatively. They still got the seven-footer in the middle there, Sonny, but basically four wing players around Aaron Gray as Auburn brings the ball up.
Well, he's only attempted two shots, and one of those was on a rebound.
100% man-to-man is this Panther team. Auburn trying to work the perimeter, and they work it down low to Dollard, working against Gray. He leans in, and Dollard can't go, but he outfights Gray for the rebound. There's Dollard again. Hook shot is up and in by Dollard.
Called second effort. Big time second effort by Dollard. He goes up and gets the rebound, shoots over Gray, who was trying to stay out of foul trouble, already has one.
Panthers across the timeline against heavy Auburn pressure. Auburn dropping back into a zone, trying to trap out front.
Well, Auburn's getting out of this trap what they want to. A little bit quicker shot, most of it outside shots.
Ball tipped free, saved by the Panthers. Baseline drive, and now they'll try the long one. And Keith Benjamin hits the three.
We said at the top of the show that Benjamin is a guy that Keith could come off that bench and hit three-pointers, and he definitely can do that. He's had four starts since he's been there. He is a good complimentary player.
Barrett with a long three, rims out, and there's Gray with a rebound. Big presence underneath. Panthers going to run now. There's Ramon all the way down in the lane. Layup is good by Ronald Ramon.
That was created by a guard that rebounds very well and also drove the ball full court and was not picked up. They got to stop a guy a little bit higher than that.
Gray knocks it loose inside, and Pittsburgh claims the turnover. There's the reverse layup up and in by Keith Benjamin.
And what a move. I couldn't think of the words. What a great spin layup off of it. He used the rim as a protector, goes to the board, and puts it up. It's Keith Benjamin, unbelievable on that drive.
Sonny, a seven-point run in just a matter of a minute and a half here by the Panthers. There you see Benjamin's three.
Inside out made that move. And this was on the drive. Ramon making the drive to the bucket, not picked up high enough, and he puts it in. And what a great spin off the glass dribble by Keith Benjamin.
You see the element of depth by the Panthers here, Sonny. That seven-point run all keyed by guys who came in off the bench. Instant offense from Ramon and from Benjamin.
Well, you know, I thought to start of this game, if Auburn could cut down on Pittsburgh's three-point shooting and somehow limit the touches that Gray gets, they would have a shot in this game. But right now, they're 4-for-6 from three, the Panthers are, and that's got to be stopped, or this game would be totally in control of Auburn had they not stopped those three-point shots. But right now, they don't have any from the three-point line. They got to get some. They got some awfully good looks, the Tigers have.
We hit the 10-minute mark. Aaron Gray came out of that last Pittsburgh timeout, highly motivated, forced a turnover and got a rebound that keyed a fast break. Now Bud Barber is back in the game for Auburn. Wayne Reed, freshman point guard for Jeff Lebo's Tigers, trying to work, nothing much there. Quick pass to Dollard. Dollard's going to have to move somewhere. Well, he'll just shoot it up, no good, and there's Gray again.
Not a good trip down the court for the Tigers then.
And there's a long pass out of bounds by the Panthers.
Not a good decision by Lavance Fields. He is a very good point guard. Takes care of the basketball, puts great value on it. He's the best handler on the ball club. And he also is a leader, and I like this kid. He may want to score a little bit more for this ball club, but hey, he gets it to him.
Tonight's game between Pittsburgh and Auburn is presented by the Cochran firm. Frank Tolbert is checked back in for Auburn, and Barrett will get a rest as Dollard works out on the high post. And trying to work it to Barber down low. Pittsburgh playing a little more attention now to Botany Barber than they did earlier.
Well, Pittsburgh's kind of packing it in. They're trying to take away that post play that was hurting them so much early. But they're killed by the drive by Quantes Robertson.
Robertson driving with the layup and draws the foul. He'll have a chance in a three-point opportunity. First basket for Quantes Robertson in the game.
Well, I tell you what he does. He puts so much pressure on the defense. He can go to his right. He can go to his left. He hesitates to dribble the shot and puts it in the bucket and draws a foul.
Foul on Ramon, his first, and the fourth team foul on Pittsburgh. Chance to convert the three-point play for Robertson. Rattles out, rebound tipped out, though, and Auburn maintains possession.
Second chance opportunities have been good for the Tigers so far. And this is a very good rebounding Pitt team.
There's the freshman trying to work. Now over to Talbert for a three, and that's long, and Barber was mugged inside, and Pittsburgh comes away with the rebound. Hear the reaction from the crowd. Here's Ramon.
Well, this is going to be a physical game, Paul.
It absolutely has been and will be. There's Gray working inside, lays it up and in, and a foul against Auburn.
I do believe the foul will be on the floor. I believe the foul was committed down on the floor.
Gray trying to go to the line, but Pitt will play it at the end line, so.
Well, that was a good call.
Second foul on Korvatny Barber, fourth Auburn team foul. Auburn cannot afford him to be in the foul trouble. There's Fields with a three-pointer on the way. He's long, but there's Gray back up and in.
Well, Gray, that's what he does best. You notice, you young people watching the game, he kept the ball above his head after he rebounded. The seven-footer has been taught very well. He's getting better every game, they say.
We mentioned a host of NBA scouts on hand, and they're here to look at Aaron Gray.
Well, he has excellent hands, and he has good shooting touch out to 12 to 15 feet.
Auburn trying to drive. Now they come back out, and the shot long, tipped away out of bounds, and we're going to have a foul on Auburn on the baseline. Looks like Frank Tolbert may be called for that one. Second foul on Tolbert, so two Auburn starters, and a little bit of first-half foul trouble, Sonny.
Well, and most of them are occurring on the backboard, a spot where they have to rebound with five guys, the Tigers do, to get anything. Pittsburgh's picking up their effort on the backboard, doing a good job of that.
Junior college transfer Archie Miaway has checked in for Auburn. Fields driving, and Fields commits the player control foul, first foul on Fields.
And that's a great rotation on defense by Frank Talbert to pick up the charge as we go to a timeout, Paul.
Little run by Pittsburgh, and the Panthers now have moved out to a five-point lead as we hit the home stretch of the first half here in Auburn.
Dreamland Barbecue first opened back in 1958 in the deep south, Tuscaloosa, Alabama, by Big Daddy John.
The mirrors.
HDTV powered by DLP. See how millions of tiny mirrors make the picture amazing.
Get great savings on select
Game show with JB and company. Have all the latest early game scores and highlights coming up. Subway post game show.
You know, Dick, you'd have a hard time convincing me that Romeo Crennel's football team hasn't gotten better over the team we saw earlier this year against Denver. I mean, this team has made progress. Last week was pathetic, but they are getting.
Then my husband and I had the chance to be parents. Two sisters wanted to be adopted together. Every day they fill us with hope and love. The things we thought we were supposed to give them. Call the Dave Thomas Foundation for Adoption. 800-ASK-DTFA. You'll change a child's life forever.
I was responsible for bruises, abrasions, and a few stitches. After I graduated, I became a nurse.
It only seemed fair.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Pittsburgh has run out to a five-point lead over the Auburn Tigers, 7:48 to go in the first half. Well, did All-America wide receiver Calvin Johnson and the 22nd-ranked Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets top number 16 Wake Forest in the ACC championship game? You can catch the Yellow Jackets and the Demon Deacons tonight at 9 on CSS. Well, Sonny, Auburn running into a spate of foul trouble here. Two starters, as Frank Tolbert and Corvatny Barber have both run into two fouls here in the early going. And you see, Jamie Dixon, in 4 years, has never lost a game in the month of December.
Yeah, well, the difference in the game is after a timeout, Pittsburgh now is going inside, and they're also doing a better job on the offensive boards. They have five offensive rebounds. Auburn was leading early because of offensive rebounds. They have four.
Reed's shot comes up short. Pittsburgh in the half court, and there's Gray. He's going to take a little jump shot from the free throw line extended, and Aaron Gray now with 6 points.
Well, because of that shot right there at 7 feet, he's going to play in the NBA for a long time if he continues to be able to keep that range.
Freshman Reed driving, puts it up, no good. Rebound cleared by Auburn. Back up. The shot won't fall for Dollar, but Dollar draws a foul inside.
Dollar looks much stronger. He's been out. He's been practicing but not playing with the team. He does look to be a stronger player. I thought he had an awfully good year last year, and I think more is expected. But he already has 7 rebounds in the game.
Dollar will shoot, too. The foul went against Keith Benjamin. First foul on Benjamin as Dollar knocks home the first one. And that is foul number 6 on Pittsburgh. Ramon is going to return to the game now.
And Barber coming back with the two fouls. I did not expect that, but he's going to have to be very careful in a situation where they now are going inside more and more. It puts a little more pressure on him.
Dollar knocks them both down. Free throw shooting has been a problem for the Auburn Tigers, but not for Josh Dollar that time. And we're back to a five-point game as we go under 7 minutes.
Man-for-man defense by Auburn. Been changing up their defenses and doing very well as they get a steal.
Robertson knocks it away. Down they go. And the ball knocks free on the baseline. But the Tigers come out and they wind up getting a three. And the three down from Archie Meaway, the junior college transfer.
They tell me if Archie Meaway can catch and shoot with his feet set, he's an outstanding shooter off the Tallahassee Community College team that went to the national finals last year to the final game. Beautiful shot, beautiful pass out by Rasheem Barrett.
Meaway knocks down the three, ball knocked loose, but the Panthers able to save it. Kendall back in the game, and he comes out front, sets up Ramon. Now they go down low. It'll be Gray working against Dollard. Not much Dollard can do about that. The shot goes awry. 3 seconds to shoot it, and the Panthers turn it over. Benjamin took steps, I think. They were about to have a shot violation anyway, Sonny.
Absolutely, because the ball did not touch the goal on the shot by Aaron Gray. LaVon Kendall comes up with the offensive rebounder. Very good offensive rebounder. Does a lot for his team. He's very respected by his team and by his coaches.
So Auburn with a chance to tie after falling down by 7 here. Midway through the first half as we go under 6 minutes.
Yeah, both teams not taking care of the basketball. Well, Auburn has 11 turnovers at this point, and the Panthers have 8.
Pittsburgh, a team that does not turn it over very much. They don't run a whole lot. Auburn has high turnovers, but they like to run. And there is almost another turnover, but Dollard picks up the loose ball in the paint, and Dollard puts home the garbage basket. He's got 10 points, and this game is tied.
Tremendous defensive effort by Josh Dollard. On the floor after the ball, picks it up, put it back, playing like a man possessed today.
Dollard playing like a man who likes to start, getting his first start of the year. There's Ramon trying to drive away to Gray, and he slams it home. And there's not much defense for Aaron Gray when he gets it in that
position.
Well,
when you can take 2 steps without dribbling and dunk it, there's not much defense for that, except the call that should be made.
Here's Robertson driving for Auburn. He is fouled as he gets the shot up. And Tez Robertson will shoot two.
Quantes Robertson puts tremendous defense, puts tremendous pressure on the defense of the opposing team because of his penetrating ability and his pass for the into the inside or out for 3-point shot. Plus, he can make the shot if left unguarded. I like this young man. I think he's a long way. He's had to play a lot of games as a young person.
He plays virtually every minute of every game. Foul was on Ramon, his second. And that was not a two-shot attempt, apparently. It was a one-plus-one, and he missed it. But Auburn with the offensive rebound. Ball loose on the floor, though. Another turnover, and here go the Panthers on the run. And Antonio Graves lays it up and in.
Now, that was a situation where Quantes Robinson got caught down inside.
Barber has a shot blocked by Gray, and here come the Panthers again.
Well, they say the Panthers will not run, but they are running with misses, and they're also running with deflections and turnovers.
Aaron Gray really working hard inside against the double team. Jump shot by Graves is good.
Well, that's Antonio Graves is just an outstanding shooter. Got a beautiful touch, got a great release on his shot.
12 points for Graves in the game, and another run by the Panthers breaking this tie. There's Dollard with the ball. Cannot move inside. They go to Barber, though, and Barber with a hook shot up and in for Corvodney Barber.
Tremendous improvement in the post play, the post presence of the Tigers. Well, the Panthers have turned up the juice here. They're now shooting over 58% from the field.
There's Gray with the ball to the baseline again. Dollard tries to block it, cannot. Gray gets it on the rim, it falls, and a foul against Auburn.
Paul, did you notice how this game changed when they started going inside to Gray? Either Gray got something or he kicked it out for somebody to get something. The post presence of Aaron Gray is why why they're a good basketball team, picked second in the country, and also why he's an All-American candidate.
First foul on Josh Dollard. Sixth on Auburn as a team. Three-point opportunity now for Aaron Gray, and the free throw is good.
What a beautiful touch that big guy has. They always say the big guy doesn't have touch. This guy got a lot of touch.
11 first-half points for Gray. And the lead extended back to 7 now by the Panthers. Another little run by Pittsburgh. There's Robertson trying to work on a baseline. Little bump out front, but he gets it away to Barber. Barber drives on Gray. Gray, again, changes the shot and comes down with a rebound.
Yeah, he does. If he doesn't block the shot, he makes you adjust your shot. But his feet were not very quick on that, so he may have a little bit of trouble footwork defensively, but it's certainly not offensively, as they're now going inside, and that's why the shooting percentage has shot up to 60%.
Gray will go to the line for 2 shots after the break. Foul on Josh Dollard will be his second. And the Pitt Panthers on a run right now, leading by 7 here in Auburn.
All right, babe, it's still time.
The construction of a new building, the renovation of a sports complex, the enhancement of an organization's capabilities. Start with the J.F. Smith Group, project managers in fundraising.
Hello, my name is Jerry Smith, president and CEO of the J.F. Smith Group. Fundraising is both an art and a science. The art is the imaginative and creative ways we interact with our volunteers. The science is in our details of our planning, our preparation of our materials, and our organization.
The result of a successful fundraising effort is the realization of dreams.
Over the past half decade, BetterBasketball.com has become the world's leader in improvement videos, bringing you 6 DVDs to build a foundation of the fundamental skills. Shooting, dribbling, passing, defending, scoring from the post, and attacking from the perimeter. Now, Better Basketball brings you the most advanced DVD ever released. Scoring without the ball. The video features unmatched detail on reacting to your teammates' dribble penetration, developing slasher moves, working off screens, and getting open when denied. The DVD even uses pro footage, so you'll see the techniques applied in real games from around the globe. Plus, you'll learn from Hall of Famer Nancy Lieberman and Jason Kidd. If your goal is to play at the next level or just plain win, get the entire Better Basketball series, put in the sweat, and then reap the rewards. Learn more about all 7 DVDs from BetterBasketball.com or call us at 1-800-BETTER-B. If you buy 6 of the videos, the 7th is free. Order now at BetterBasketball.com.
The Pittsburgh Panthers with a run have opened up a 7-point lead, and Sonny Smith, they have done it by figuring out how to get the ball inside to their All-America candidate.
Well, that's right, and inside means anything out to 15 feet. Aaron Gray can score outside. He can score on the move down the lane. The guy is, hey, the game has totally changed since they started going in. Their shooting percentage went from down in the low 40s up to 60% now. He has 11 points and 6 rebounds at this point and all that. And he's remained very patient. He hasn't forced anything. They went to him, and he has certainly delivered. And that's the difference in this game. And he also has put Auburn in a world of hurt from a foul situation because he now have all their big guys in foul trouble.
Yeah, Dollard and Barber both with 2 fouls each. And Frank Tolbert, the wing player, with 2 fouls as well for the Auburn Tigers. So Gray set to go to the line to shoot 2. And try to extend this to the biggest lead of the game for Pittsburgh.
Paul, I'm surprised that he's not shooting better from the free throw line because of that beautiful touch that he has. He's only shooting coming in here from the free throw line 67%. Now, he looks much, much better than that. But this is a guy they say is just getting better every time out.
Well, Gray is now 4 out of 5 from the line in this game. Auburn rebounds, and the Panthers with their biggest lead thus far, an 8-point lead. Robertson moving. Gray cut him off. He gets it on the baseline to Barrett, and the shot blocked by Gray, out of bounds, back to Auburn. Another blocked shot for Aaron Gray, and he has really been a presence. Auburn with 16 early points in the paint, Sonny, but Aaron Gray has effectively shut that down, and he's going to get a rest now.
Well, when they say post presence, if a guy has post presence defensively and offensively, that means you've got a great post player.
8-point lead for Pittsburgh at 38-30 as Auburn plays it on the end line with 16 to shoot.
Pittsburgh on a 10-2 run, and that's because they started going inside.
There's the freshman Reed, rims out, but Dollard with a rebound, and Dollard up, no, and the offensive rebound from the backside for the Auburn Tigers. Looks to be Rasheem Barrett with his first basket
of
the game.
That's his first basket, and he's a guy that has to put something on the board for that. He hasn't been able to get many touches today because of the defense of the Panthers.
Second chance opportunity, big for Auburn then to stop that run. Here's Pittsburgh again in the half court.
Yeah, they
Auburn
can go
trying to trap.
Auburn can go back to the 1-3-1 trap that's been so good to them over the years. Jeff Lebo does a tremendous job with this defense.
They get it inside this time though, and it's up and in for Biggs. Biggs with 4 points with the easy layup.
Well, this defense depends on how well your baseline man on the 1-3-1 plays. And Reed was out of position then, Dwayne Reed was out of position, created a situation where it's an easy basket for the Panthers.
Panthers catch a foul on the freshman point guard, and that's going to go against Biggs. First foul on Biggs.
Terrell, I believe, might have set an illegal screen there. Since he had him down on the floor like that, I think he might have been illegal. I think he's a guy that has great potential for them. He's only a sophomore. He's lost 20 pounds. He's had 11 points 3 times this year. So that's a great backup guy to Aaron Gray. And he's also, you can play him well together. They complement one another.
Lead for the 1-1. And the free throw is up and good for the young freshman, his first points of this game. Free throw shooting has been a problem for the Auburn Tigers. And Sonny, you think that's unusual considering Jeff Lebo, one of the all-time great free throw shooters.
Yes, and that has nothing to do with, you know, I always talk about how great the guys that can shoot free throws. This free throw situation is more a head game. It's a confidence situation more than anything else. You can see some people with great touch just can't get their rhythm and their confidence down. I think it's more a head job than anything else.
Auburn cuts the Panther lead to 6. Here's Pittsburgh on the attack as we go under 2 minutes in the first half. Drive by Graves and a foul on the floor before Graves can get the shot up.
When you're in a 1-3-1 defense, as they have been, and they've been alternating between men, you've got to stop penetration into the middle of the floor. That is the guy that plays the post and also the guy that plays the back of the zone, and they're not getting that done right now, and it's hurting them.
First foul on Archie Miaway, 8th foul on Auburn, and the free throw no good by Graves. Auburn able to clear the rebound, 3 on the way. Up and in by Archie Miaway, his 2nd 3 of the game.
Well, the scouting report on Archie Miaway is if he has his feet set, he's a great shooter. He's a good catch-and-shoot shooter, not a good off the dribble.
Auburn back within 3. They're falling behind by 8, and the 3-pointer can bring you back quickly. Graves trying to work against that Auburn zone. Baseline jumper by the Panthers, and Benjamin on the board again. Benjamin now with 7 points for Pittsburgh.
I tell you, the defense is just outstanding, but the baseline is being played by a very small man, and he's got great quickness, but he doesn't understand the defense quite as well, being a freshman, but he will. And Dollard, for instance, because of the foul trouble, has a double-double in the first half.
Under a minute 20 now, a 5-point lead for Pittsburgh, and here's freshman Dwayne Reed trying to set things for Auburn against that Pittsburgh man-to-man. Miaway thought about another 3. They'll set it back up again. There's Gray coming out front. Inside they go Dollard, but Dollard will not challenge Gray. Back out to Meaway. Rainbow three will not go, and there's Kendall to clear for Pittsburgh.
It was not a good shot. Did not have enough time off the clock, and shooting a contested shot is not good.
And a foul on the floor against Auburn as Fields tries to drive.
I think this is a anticipated situation. It looked like he was going to push him, but I don't think you're going to find the push here. There was no contact, and a college call. Bobby Donato is an outstanding official. He anticipated the call, and he could have called a push earlier, and that may be what he's telling Jeff Lebo right now.
One plus the bonus for Fields. Knocks the first one down. He'll have a second opportunity. Halftime, we'll be talking with Damian Fishback. He's talking about baseline jump shooters. The Fish could knock them down. We'll also have highlights from the first half, as well as a look at our first half statistics. As Pittsburgh tried to open up that lead again, they got it back out to six now.
Damian Fishback not only was a great player, but is a great person. And that'll be a tremendous interview. Stay tuned for that.
Fields knocks down both free throws, and the lead back at seven now for Pittsburgh. Entry pass to Dollard as he tries to work against Biggs. Gets the hook up and in.
I'm telling you, Josh Dollard is having a day. He's having a night. He's having a career tonight. What a great, that makes him 6-for-12 and with 10 rebounds. That's not bad.
Fields trying to work out front against the freshman Dwayne Reed. He'll get a reset on the count. Under 20 seconds to go here in the half. 15 on the shot clock. Pittsburgh trying to play for that final shot. They've got eight on the shot clock, and the clocks are just about a second apart.
Keys for Dollard not to foul here.
As Fields gets it away, Benjamin with a jump shot, no good, and that's going to be the end of the first half as the Auburn Tigers cut an eight-point margin back down to five against the number two team in the country. Tigers with some foul problems to address at halftime, but Auburn has played well against the number two team in the country. Pittsburgh leads it by five at halftime in Auburn, Alabama.
We're challenging Honda and Toyota head-on at the Hyundai Challenge Year-End Sales Event. It's your last, best, biggest chance to get big cash back on a lineup that offers you better quality, better fuel efficiency, a better warranty, and better year-end savings on models like the award-winning Sonata. We're up to the challenge, and you'll put big cash back in your pocket, but only if you hurry. Get a new Sonata V6 with up to $2,000 cash back or 1.9%.
Right.
0.007.
or something.
See, he's out right there, and it still reads one on the clock.
Of course, the instant replay call comes from upstairs now and not on a challenge situation.
That's the end of the game. We'll go to overtime.
A little surprised at that, aren't you?
But that they ran the short play? Absolutely.
No, I'm surprised that they called the game over. I thought that Kansas City earned a chance for a final play.
Now, if you do it in real time, it's much easier to judge in real time. Listen for the whistle. See, it's after it went zero with the whistle blow, so the clock never stopped.
There was more time left when he ball hit out of bounds, but there's the human factor there, and just seeing it and blowing the whistle and the...
Well, plus real time. You know, not seeing that thing inch down in slow motion. You see it in real time, it goes, you know, 3, 2, 1, it's over.
So the coin toss to see who gets the ball first.
Gentlemen, we'll play one overtime sudden death period. First team that scores will win the game. Each team will have two timeouts. Replay will be handled upstairs in the booth. Kansas City, it's your toss and coin. What is your call? Heads is called. It is a head. You've won the toss.
Kansas City.
You want the ball? Stay right where you're at. Kansas City has won, elected to receive. Good luck, men.
And they will go into the wind here in the sudden death overtime. We'll be back for the result.
The game is on the line. The pressure's on. Here's the situation. You've got two children. College tuition is in sight. Retirement is breathing down your neck. And
Who do you go to in the clutch? Over 65 million customers rely on us when their money is on the line. Insurance, investments, retirement. AIG, the strength to be there.
With more power, more capability, and the most fuel efficiency, the only way to improve the new Sierra is to back it with one of the best warranties in the business. Introducing the all-new 2007 GMC Sierra. We examined everything, then stood behind it with the GM 100,000-mile warranty. That's professional grade.
We begin overtime with a reminder tonight on 60 Minutes, the man whose idea is changing the way millions of Americans are watching movies in their own homes. Followed by new episodes of The Amazing Race, Cold Case, and Without a Trace. Tonight on CBS, America's number one network. And, of course, the wild card importance of this game, especially for Kansas City in position now with Denver, the best wild card records in the AFC. And Cleveland trying to play spoiler. And, of course, all the teams below Kansas City rooting at this point for the Browns.
And remember, they won the toss, Kansas City did. The number one advantage they have is winning the toss. Number two is Dante Hall's returning it.
And Hall stands at the five-yard line. 11 career kickoff or kick and punt return touchdowns. Wynn carries that one to the goal line. 10. And he's hit at the 20, breaks a tackle, and then is covered right at the 20-yard line. Well, the Browns have been good on special teams all season long. That has been one of their bright spots.
That's a tribute to Jerry Rosberg, their special teams coordinator, who does a great job with their special teams. But the job now is up to this Cleveland's D.
The Browns have not been in a sudden death game, overtime game this year. Kansas City has. Second game of the season, they lost at Denver in an all field goal game, 9-6 in overtime. Trent Green with four touchdown passes today. He opens with a pass and completes it to Larry Johnson, 25, and ridden out at the 27. And Cameron Wembley was there to make the play. Boy, Green just did get that throw away, floating it across field.
Well, you get a good idea of the size of Larry Johnson when a Cameron Wembley gets out on him, and they look about the same size. You got an outside linebacker slash defensive end and a running back. And it took a guy that size to bring him down and try to tackle him high.
Yeah, Wimberly 6'3", 245.
That's a fair fight.
Second and short, first down. Johnson crosses the 30. And he's over the century mark once again, as he has been on almost every game he's played this year. In overtime, as we mentioned, they lost back in game two in Denver. No touchdowns scored in that one.
And if you have a formula for Herman Edwards in this overtime, it contains a lot of Larry Johnson. Just like we talked about them really eating up the rest of that clock there when there was 8:55 left. Number 27 is the key to a drive here.
He's carried 27 times for 106 yards. Not this time. Green going deep for Kennison. Incomplete. That's been long the favorite connection of these two. A flag down, and it's in the secondary of the Browns.
Yeah, that's in that illegal contact area against the defense.
It was not thrown in the direction of Kennison, but over the center of the field.
Prior to the pass, illegal contact, number 55, defense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Willie McGinnis got a piece of somebody. So first down out to the 37-yard line. Just looking ahead, should the Chiefs get in position for a field goal try. Lawrence Tyne's longest was the winning field goal against San Diego this season at Arrowhead when he hit from 53 yards. But he'll be kicking into the wind today.
Yeah, he's not going to hit it from 53 here.
Johnson trying to wear down this Browns defense. With that wonderful offensive wall in front of him, especially in the middle with veterans Casey Wigman at center, Brian Waters, a Pro Bowler at left guard, and the venerable Will Shields, a Pro Bowler.
ESPN Monday Night Football, Mondays 8:30 Eastern.
ESPN, serving sports fans around the world.
To receive ESPN, please call your cable or satellite provider.
Keyed by an early run by Korvatny Barber, the Auburn Tigers opened up a lead to start this game. But the Pittsburgh Panthers, led by their All-American center Aaron Gray with his 12 points, now lead it by five. It's 44-39 Pittsburgh at the half.
The last sound you hear before you step on the field.
Click, clack.
Quick, quack.
Click, quack.
Click, quack.
I think the air is coming.
I'm just ecstatic with this bike, Polly. You did a great job.
Thanks, Dad. You're the best.
Everyone, a round of applause for Polly.
My father is a very warm, nurturing man.
Hey, Polly. I was thinking, it's so nice out, why don't you take a ride down to Napa and pick up those parts?
Wow, this is awesome! I love you, Dad, and I love going to Napa.
Hey, you should take Mikey.
Mom, shouldn't we pick a place to meet? If you're not home, should we go to the neighbors? Should I pick up Sophia at the babysitter's house?
There's no reason not to have a plan in case of a terrorist attack.
How do we keep in touch with each other if the phones don't work?
And some extremely good reasons why you should.
If we can't make it home, who will pick us up?
Talk to your family about what you would do in case of an emergency. For more information, go to www.ready.gov.
We've never had the pleasure of meeting.
Our kids play different sports.
You wouldn't recognize me at the dry cleaners. But if you ever need it, I'm ready to save your life.
When you help the American Red Cross, you help America.
The Pittsburgh Panthers lead it by five at halftime. Sonny Smith, the Auburn Tigers got off to a pretty good start in the first half, and they did it in a surprising way by going to inside basketball led by Korvatny Barber and Josh Dollard.
One thing been a weakness for Auburn is post presence inside. Josh Dollard to provide it. Korvatny Barber's getting better. And also some beautiful feeds from Quantez Robson. Josh Dollard just took over getting second shots as a double-double at the half. And that's a great jump hook from Josh right there. It's good to see him back. And also there is a beautiful play inside on a pass from Quantez Robertson, who has distributed the ball. Gray, who turned into a force late in the ball game on a little jump hook. And Antonio Graves, who was 5 for 5 in the first half. One of the big differences in the game.
Well, Gray and Graves with 12 points each for Pittsburgh. 12 points as well for Dollard, 11 for Korvatny Barber. As you look at the stats, Pittsburgh shot lights out down the stretch to get up to 61% from the field. Turnovers, Auburn forced 8 while only giving up 5. But off the bench, the 9 deep Pittsburgh Panthers really made it count, doubling up the Auburn Tigers.
That shows you the depth of this basketball team. They play 9 people, and they give them extended minutes, and they go to them immediately. Ramon off the bench immediately hits a 3 when they bring him in. They and Antonio Graves just went wild. They take him out, and they replace him with someone else. Their 3-point shooting was one of the big differences in points off the bench. That's it.
And, of course, Auburn unable to connect from 3-point range. Archie Mealway had a couple off the bench late for Auburn, but the Tigers unable to knock down the outside jumper. And once Gray took away the inside down the stretch, Auburn didn't have an answer.
Well, yeah, you're exactly right, but I tell you one thing. Jeff Lebo's got to feel good about his basketball team because he now has somewhat of a post presence inside, which has been missing most of the year. Kovatny's had everything on his shoulders. Now he's getting a little help from Dollard, and this is a good thing.
A little momentum surge for Auburn down the stretch. They cut an 8-point lead to 5. The number 2 Pittsburgh Panthers lead it by 5 here in Auburn at halftime. We'll have the second half when we come back.
The construction of a new building, the renovation of a sports complex, the enhancement of an organization's capabilities. Start with the J.F. Smith Group, project managers in fundraising.
Hello, my name is Jerry Smith, president and CEO of the J.F. Smith Group. Fundraising is both an art and a science. The art is the imaginative and creative ways we interact with our volunteers. The science is in our details of our planning, our preparation of our materials, and our organization.
The result of a successful fundraising effort is the realization of dreams.
Dreamland Barbecue first opened back in 1958 in the deep south, Tuscaloosa, Alabama, by Big Daddy John Bishop. He used to say ain't nothing like him nowhere about his barbecue ribs and his customers. You see, over the years, lots of celebrities, pro athletes, and some Hollywood folks have been to Dreamland. But to Big Daddy and all the folks cooking and smiling at Dreamland, everyone who comes in is treated like a celebrity. So come on, see for yourself why we say Dreamland Barbecue. Ain't nothing like them nowhere.
I'm tall enough to reach the monkey bars.
I can reach anything on the counter, even things you think I can't.
I can understand everything you spell.
I'm the tallest kid in my class.
I'm getting pretty big. But to help me survive a car crash, I still need you to give me a boost.
Until they're 4'9", use a booster seat in the car and don't let them down.
So what's the biggest issue in America today?
Segregation still exists, racism.
The repression and oppression of women.
The educational system.
Stem cell research.
Homeless people.
Cloning government.
Healthcare.
Taxation.
So is there anything you're doing to help make a change?
I'm not really doing anything.
Got me on that one.
The Auburn Tigers hosting the number 2 Pittsburgh Panthers, and Auburn jumped out to a 7-point lead very early in this game. Aaron Gray, along with Antonio Graves, the leading scorers for the Pittsburgh Panthers, both fueling a mid-first-half comeback that allowed Pittsburgh to build an 8-point lead late. However, Josh Dollard and Corvodney Barber, working mostly inside, able to hold off the surge and cut that lead to 5 by halftime. Archie Miaway with a couple of late first-half threes that also helped the Auburn Tigers. Sonny Smith, a little bit of a surprise. Auburn with 26 points in the paint to 14 for Pittsburgh, but you reverse that. The Panthers with 16 bench points to just 8 for Auburn, and that's only have a 5-point margin for the number 2 rated Panthers.
The big deal in this game is Pittsburgh. The Panthers shot 60% in the first half, and Auburn is within 5. They got to feel good about themselves. Now, if they can come out and get off to a quick start, get right back in this thing, we're going to see a game. I think it's going to depend on who gets off to the quickest start here in this first 5 minutes. And let's see how the game, if it changed. Will Auburn now be able to continue the post presence and get points inside, or will they pick up on the outside shooting? Pittsburgh is a team that is very solid, even all the way down the 9th man on the bench.
3 of the Auburn starters on the floor with 2 fouls. Ronald Raymond has 2 fouls for Pittsburgh. Nobody in serious foul trouble in the early going. Second half inside Dollard. He dishes to Barber, and Barber lays it in. And that's the way Auburn started this game. They start the second half with a Corvodney Barber layup.
Well, that's 2 post players working together. Josh Dollard makes a drive, draws the defense, drops the ball off to Barber, and he puts it in the bucket.
Pittsburgh starting off the second half, working it down low. No surprise there. And Gray misses. Auburn is there to clear the rebound. That's Talbert coming from the backside.
A good job of defending Aaron Gray then. Staying behind him with the hands up, not fouling him, not giving him a good look at the bucket.
Talbert going to work the wing. He drives on Gray, puts it up. No good. Rebound tipped up and in. I think that was Barber again.
Rodney Barber might have injured himself a little bit on that. He's come up a little bit gimpy there, but he's doing a tremendous job of fighting the backboard tonight.
Auburn with the first 4 points of the second half. It's a 1-point game, and the Tigers drop into a man-to-man now. That's Cook working on the far wing. He is a threat to take a 3, but decides not to, as Pittsburgh working it around, trying to work it to their All-American candidate, Aaron Gray. Cook with a jump shot, no good, and Robertson is there to clear for Auburn.
Mike Cook, a guy we didn't see much of the first half because of foul trouble.
Auburn with a chance to take a lead here. A minute and a half into the second half. There's Barber, drives, and has his shot rejected by Aaron Gray.
He's a presence around that goal, offensively or defensively, Aaron Gray is.
There's Cook again. Jump shot up and in by the transfer from East Carolina, Mike Cook, his 4th point in the game.
Very athletic. Can go to his right, can go to his left. Uses the dribble very, very well, and is a very unselfish kid.
The lead goes back to three for Pittsburgh. Barber with the ball, trying to work outside. Not much there for the Tigers. Drive inside, they get it to Barber. Hook shot is no good. And again, Aaron Gray changing the shot and clearing the rebound for Pittsburgh.
You don't have to deflock them as long as you can make them alter the shots.
Quick shot up for Pitt, no good. And there's Dollar with a rebound, has his pocket picked though, and Cook lays it up and in. And Mike Cook makes his presence known with two quick baskets for the Panthers in the second half.
Mike had been on the bench for a long time. He comes out firing up, trying to get himself into the game, and has ended up being a very positive thing.
6 points for Cook, and the lead back to five. There's Dollar for three, off the rim, no good. There's Barber again with a rebound up and drawing the foul.
You know, if you've been watching this Tiger team play for 2 years, you realize how much improvement Rodney Barber has made. He's a much stronger guy, and he's a much more confident guy, and he's fighting the offensive board very well. Second shots will be a big factor in this ball game.
Second foul on Aaron Gray in the game, first of the half on Pittsburgh. Barber for two, and he makes the first one. Well, Rodney Barber now with 16 points in the game, including five quick ones in the first 3 minutes of the second half. Second free throw rims out, and there's Cook again clearing the rebound, and he'll bring it up quickly to Gray. Gray drives all the way, can't get it home, gets his own miss, and is knocked away inside. Auburn comes away with a loose ball, and now what do we have?
Mike Cook has drawn a charge, and that was a good call, actually. He did a tremendous job of creating a turnover after. You're going to see a tremendous block. A drive down the lane by Kendall is blocked. Back up and blocked by Kravotny Barber, and Quantes Robinson turns around. Mike Cook draws the charge.
On Robertson, that'll be his second foul. First on Auburn as a team. And it goes right back to Auburn, a turnover on the inbounds play. They get an offensive foul on Aaron Gray, and Sonny, that's two quick ones in the second half. Three fouls now on Aaron Gray.
Well, this is two teams playing extremely hard, both playing very physical. The referee's going to keep it under control.
There's Talbot with a long jumper, no good, and the rebound cleared by Graves. Cook up on the run. Inside they go to Aaron Gray. Gray working against Barber. Back out to Cook. Jump shot by Cook is good, and Mike Cook is a big force. He has all six Pittsburgh points in the second half.
Well, Mike Cook has made his presence known. He's on the bench with foul trouble early in the ball game. Here's a guy that can score points in bunches. So take a look at the pass by Kendall out of the post and knocks it down from the outside by Mike Cook.
Aaron Gray is going to get a rest with three fouls, and Terrell Diggs will come in.
That's
we
big.
Have a quick stoppage in play here.
That's big three fouls there. I can tell you that right now. You're going to see the jumper outside by Cook. It looks he's got a great release on his jump shot.
I thought he was on the line when he shot it, but they're looking to see if it's a three, and that's a stoppage in play, and he may have been outside the line. That may be a three for Cook.
I believe his foot might have touched the line, and you know, I did such a good job of giving you the last one, Paul. I believe... But I don't think I could go to court. I tell you, this is going to be a tough call. I don't think they can make this call. If they call three to start with, they're going to keep it that way.
It was a two to begin with, and apparently
they kept it that way.
It'll stay at two, so.
It was very hard to detect from the line.
So Mike Cook with 6 points.
Jamie's getting after Tim Higgins a little bit on that, but I think they made the correct call.
So Auburn set to play. Again, trailing by seven.
Dollard, who had an unbelievable first half, gets a little bit of a walk right there. There's a pressure being put on him by Terrell Biggs.
Auburn got the ball down low where they wanted it, but Biggs, with a big presence inside, forced the walk, and the turnover gives it back to Pittsburgh. They're going to be looking for Mike Cook right now.
He's got it.
Fields. Way to Graves. Cook coming on top, driving down the lane. Gets rid of it to Biggs, and Biggs has a shot rejected. Out of bounds back to the Panthers with 11 to shoot.
Well, it's been a highlight film with what Kravotny Barber and Josh Dollard has done in the first half and the start of the second.
Pittsburgh by 7 as we take our first break in the second half. You see the block by Barber.
Yesterday is spoken for, but the future is your own to dream and plan for. At Alpha, we're in the business of tomorrows, making them safer, smarter, more comfortable. And it starts with the conversation. Let's talk about tomorrow.
We're challenging Honda and Toyota head-on at the Hyundai Challenge Year-End Sales Event. It's your last, best, biggest chance to get big cash back on a lineup that offers you better quality, better fuel efficiency, a better warranty, and better year-end savings on models like the award-winning Sonata. We're up to the challenge, and you'll put big cash back in your pocket, but only if you hurry. Get a new Sonata V6 with up to $2,000 cash back or 1.9% APR.
The last sound you hear before you step on the field.
Click, clack.
I think the air is coming.
Click, clack. Click, clack. Click, clack.
I think the air is coming.
Well, Auburn closed the gap to within a point, but Mike Cook has fueled a Pittsburgh rally that has the Panthers leading by 7 here with just under 16 minutes to go. The experts weigh in Monday on Sports Night as NFL analyst Victor Green and recruiting expert Jamie Newberg visit the crew and catch Georgia State basketball coach Michael Perry live in studio. Don't miss Sports Night Monday at 6 and 11 only on CSS.
You know, we haven't mentioned the name Jamie Dixon tonight. That guy is 42-1 in non-conference play since coaching the Pittsburgh Panthers. That's a pretty good job with 72 wins overall.
Absolutely. Ball back three, stolen by Robertson. He is away to Talbert, and Talbert lays it up and in. And that's a nice job by Robertson.
Well, it's a good job of gathering himself to lay the ball into the bucket and not drawing a foul.
Well, Auburn again forcing the turnover, and you're right, Jamie Dixon with a superb record. Baseline drive is blocked, but Pittsburgh able to save the ball. Long jumper is good from the far side by Fields.
Well, you talk about a solid basketball team that's solid in every position. The Pittsburgh Panthers are, and they give you great effort. He's got to be pleased with the effort that he's getting out of this play.
Auburn in the half court against that Pittsburgh man-to-man. Pittsburgh has equal their largest lead of the game, and the shot falls off by Dollard. And here's Pitt trying to run. There's Fields all the way down, up and in by LaVance Fields. He's got 5 quick points, and the biggest lead of the game, 10 points by Pittsburgh. Jeff Lebo going to take a 30-second timeout.
LaVance Fields is very, very quick out of Brooklyn. He has 49 assists up to this point. They've said that he needs to score more. But I tell you what, he doesn't take bad shots. He knocked down a wide-open three, and he also made a great drive to the basket. And they're saying if his defense improved, he could become one of the better point guards in the Big East.
So 44 assists coming into this game against only 10 turnovers, so he handles the ball pretty well. Here you see Auburn coming off the turnover, Sonny.
Yeah, Quantes Robinson making a great pass to Frank Talbert to lay into the basket. And then there's Fields hiding and protecting the basketball very well, going to the basketball to the goal with power and with strength. This guy's a good basketball player.
Well, Levon Kendall has not scored for Pittsburgh, but he has been a force in this game, initiating the fast break and changing shots down low, especially with Aaron Gray out and a little bit of foul trouble.
Well, he does whatever they ask him to do. He can do a lot of things. He's a very versatile player, and the guy just is very unselfish. He doesn't need to score. I understand he's quite a musician. His father is a professional musician in Canada.
He's out of British Columbia, one of three seniors in the starting lineup, and this Pittsburgh team is a senior-laden team, another reason why a lot of people are picking him to have a big run this season when the NCAAs roll around in about 3 months.
Well, I can see why they pick them. They're solid defensively. They are a very deep basketball team. They got great post presence, and even though the percentages might indicate different, they are an outstanding three-point shooting overall, because Antonio Grace can make it, Ramon can make it, Benjamin can make it, and just as we looked at just a minute ago, Fields makes the outside jumper also.
Yeah, they're a team that really seems to know their individual roles and play within those roles. And they got to keep Gray on the bench. They've actually extended the lead since Gray went out.
Yeah, and you know what? They're on a run. They made a big-time run with him out of the basketball game.
Five quick points, all scored by Fields since Gray went out. And here's Auburn playing the ball, trying to get back in this game, trailing by 10.
Well, good shots is the key to getting back.
There's Robertson driving and trapped on the baseline and gets it out of bounds, and it's off his foot out of bounds. That'll be a turnover on the Auburn Tigers.
A little bit of a quick shot by Quantes, but he has to go to the goal occasionally because he is getting so much better at that, because he dropped off for a lot of points in the first half.
Long-term, having Dwayne Reed will help Robertson as well. There's the entry pass knocked away by Auburn, and Pittsburgh will play it at the end line. They tried to work it down low to Biggs. Tonight's game between Pittsburgh and Auburn is presented by the Cochran firm.
Yeah, Pittsburgh on a 12-3 run. That's what they've been good at, runs. Good deflection on defense.
Little turnover forced by Auburn. Miaway takes it out of the air and gets it to Quantes Robertson. And Robertson is cut off, and a foul is going to be called on Kendall as Robertson tried to work the right wing.
Kendall's a very physical player. He's going to draw some fouls, and some are going to look foolish, but he plays hard all the time.
First personal on Kendall, third on Pittsburgh. And Corvodney Barber goes to the bench for Auburn as Frank Talbert's going to check back in. Auburn with a pretty small lineup out there now.
Auburn needs to work themselves back into the game by taking some good shots. A high pick is refused by Quantes, and he makes the pass to the wing.
Robertson thought about the three-pointer. Nothing there, and he's away to Miaway. And there's a foul to the backside. They were working it on the baseline, trying to get the ball to Josh Dollard. And the foul goes against Kendall.
Well, physical play by extending the hands and pushing people is not going to be, you're not going to be able to get by with that this year. That's been a very big part of the game of basketball. Officials have clamped down on that now.
Second foul on Kendall in the last 2 minutes. There's Talbert trying to drive and can't penetrate at all as Pittsburgh has really sealed off the defense. Talbert again drives, nothing there. And Robertson for three, and it will not fall. Rebound inside, and Auburn saves it. There's Barrett driving in the lane, and he lays it up and in.
Barrett has not had many looks at the goal. Gets a good look there on a beautiful drive to the basket, created by a defense running out at him and taking advantage of the defender.
Machine Barrett with 4 points, his first basket in the second half. Pitt, extra steps on the sideline.
The 1-3-1 zone by Auburn is to get you to speed up play, and they do a good job of it there, and they get a run. Now, this is a great drive by Rasheem Barrett. He takes the ball to his right extremely well as the defender comes on the run toward him. Because they know he's a three-point shooter, they get out to get the hand extended. He makes a nice drive.
Jamie Dixon gets Ronald Ramon back in the game, and he'll give Graves a rest.
Well, they need to look for him to take the three, because that's what he comes in there doing.
You see the turnovers. Auburn has forced 12 Pittsburgh turnovers. That is high for the Panthers, but Auburn has been unable to hit the outside shots and take full advantage of the turnovers they've forced. BOA works it around to Talbert. Ramon tightly guarding Talbert.
Well, the defense has picked up. They're packing it in. They're playing position defense, doing a tremendous job of sealing off the block.
Auburn with three to shoot, and they turn it over with a walk before the shot clock can expire. Coach Jeff Lebo a little bit frustrated now as the Panthers have really turned up the defense.
The reason the frustration is taking place, the game is now at a walk. And this is a tempo that Pittsburgh wants. They do a tremendous job of their half-court defense. Alder is now playing half-court basketball.
Hit in the half-court set. There's Ramon for three. No good, but weak side rebounding by Kendall. And the Panthers get another 25 seconds, 35 seconds.
Auburn got to do a better job of not allowing second-chance opportunities.
Good opportunity for the Panthers now. They'll run the clock down a little bit, get in that half-court set. Ramon for three again. And he knocks that one down. And we mentioned he's a 57-point three-point shooter.
He doesn't come off the bench looking to pass. He comes off the bench looking to, and they set great screens for him. That was a good diagonal screen set to free him up after a dribble move by Fields.
8 points by Ramon. He has two threes and a foul called as Robertson tries to penetrate. Foul's going to be on Fields. LaVance Fields gets his second foul, 15th foul on Pittsburgh. Auburn will have the ball when we come back.
Next time, use FedEx.
Bad people, the gang members in the neighborhood. My brother, he wouldn't be happy at all if I was to tell him I was going to drop out of school. He would not approve of that, because then that's going to be two of us not handling our business.
Me and my friends are close, and we all believe in each other. I know they could graduate, even if it takes them longer than the 4 years.
We have classes together, so
we study together. We help each other at our homework.
Realized we messed up in the past.
Failed a couple classes before, not doing as much work as I should be doing. My two best friends, they keep me working hard.
Nobody likes me. Nobody. Maybe it's because I like to attack people. Men, women, kids. I can reduce them to weak, stammering, confused, scared imitations of their former selves. If they don't stop me, I just might leave them that way for life. I am a stroke.
Learn to recognize a stroke and act quickly. Time lost is brain lost.
The Pittsburgh Panthers have opened up an 11-point lead. Sonny Smith, Auburn is forcing the turnovers they need to stay in this game or
good
get
job.
Back in this game, but they're not hitting anything from outside, and that has really kept them from having any kind of run to get back in it.
Absolutely. Paul, if somebody said to you, Auburn is beating Pittsburgh in the paint, you would say no. And if you thought that Pittsburgh was getting everything from the outside, they're doing a tremendous job from three-point land. That's most of the points have been off from threes, and that's really been good.
Auburn works it inside again. Shot off the back of the rim by Barber. And Kendall was there to clear that rebound one more time.
Out of the timeout, you're generally going to find that Auburn's going to get a good shot. Jeff Lebo is very good at designing plays out of a timeout.
11-point lead, the largest of the game for the Panthers. You see Biggs trying to drive outside. Away to Ramon, and it has really turned in to a half-court game.
Well, it's now a half-court basketball game, and they get the shots for the people that they're looking for. 55% field goal percentage for Pittsburgh to 42 for Auburn.
And they finally get the ball up. Kendall gets it on the rim as the shot clock about to expire, and Auburn able to claim the rebound. Barber hustling on the far side. There's Talbert looking for the shot. Back out he comes, and Miaway. Three on the way, no good. And again, Pittsburgh able to clear. It's one and out for Auburn.
That's a backward pass on the fast break. Generally a trailer. And that was a trailer on the wing by Ramon. A beautiful pass from Fields.
Jeff Lebo going to get a quick timeout as Ramon has his third three of the game. And Ronald Ramon, we told you in the early going, he was hitting 57% outside the arc. He is deadly when you don't get a hand in his face out there.
Anytime your point guard, it will take the ball and draw the defense to him and kick sideways or backwards and get that three, you're going to get something good. And he did a beautiful job of that. Credit Field with a great assist.
Ramon, 11 points in the game, three threes he has for the Pittsburgh Panthers. And he is certainly a weapon that they can take full advantage of because of their inside presence.
Paul, I can see this team being a factor in the Big East because of their ability to control tempo. They can beat you outside. They can beat you inside. They can play defense, very solid defense. And some people have said they're not as good as last year. I think they're as good. They're just not as physical as last year's team. And this is a very good team right here.
With all those seniors, Jamie Dixon has a crew that really knows their roles. And as a coach, you can really appreciate guys who understand what they're out there to do and don't try to do too much.
That is a great word right there, defining the roles. Pittsburgh has 8 for 13 from three.
Auburn needs to knock down a couple of threes.
There's Robertson working. He drives and lays it up and in. And that's a nice move by Quantes Robertson.
Quantes did a wonderful job of looking the defender off, thinking it, making him think he's going to pass, hesitate, and taking it to the goal. This young man's got some skill.
He is just a sophomore, as most of this team are. Talbert flashes, trying for the steal, did not get it. Gray is back in. Working the baseline against Barber. Fields will back it out with 12 seconds to shoot. Fields driving inside off the front of the rim. Reed is able to clear the rebound for Auburn. Young freshman Reed getting playing time against quality opposition.
And doing a good job, by the way.
Here's Reed driving all the way down the lane, lays it up and in. No. They're going to call a charge. Raymond draws the charge. It'll be a turnover and a player control, and they'll wipe out the basket.
Well, this is a very close call here. It looked like the defense was not set, leaning in, and I do believe I was correct. Bobby might have missed that, even though he's a great official, by the way. You have three great officials in this game.
Three veteran officials who've been around for quite some time. And
it's okay if you're a great miss one occasionally, right?
Everybody, nobody's perfect. Right?
I might have missed that call myself. I didn't miss it when I was coaching.
No, you never missed one. Your team never committed a foul when you were coaching.
No. Our defense was let them throw it up there so we can get the ball back.
That's right. That's right. Here's Pittsburgh with the ball. Ramon working on the point to bring the ball up now. They get it inside to Gray. Gray and Dollard bumping, and they're going to call that one. Dollard giving it to Gray from the backside.
And they're going to allow you to push a little bit around the goal because there's going to be a foul on every play. But once the guy receives the ball, they will not allow you to push like that. And that was a good call by the official.
Third team foul on Auburn. And Cook will take the inbounds pass.
You would think to the way the game is flowing right now that everybody's kind of asleep. But it's being very productive for the Panthers as they keep working the ball and get the ball to somebody for a wide open shot.
Graves from the outside cannot hit. And Talbert on the rebound. He's fouled by Graves as he comes across midcourt. Foul on Graves will be his first. That's number six on Pittsburgh here in the second half.
Frank Talbert is a guy that has, and we haven't heard much from him in this half, but here's a guy that can explode and do some things for you.
Oh, but one of the reasons Auburn got out to that quick 7-point lead in the first half.
Yes.
Before the Panthers adjusted.
Good job of helping by the postman on the high ball screen by the Tigers.
Auburn trying to work it around the outside. There's Barrett. Fallaway jumper by Barrett is good. Barrett with 6 points in the game.
I like this young man because he can score off the dribble and he can score standing. And he has a scorer's mentality. He has a chance to be a good player. He's a young player. It's going to be good.
Sophomore out of Atlanta, and there's a touch foul on the far side against Auburn. It'll be against Robertson. Third foul on Robertson and fourth on Auburn as a team.
Well, what happened? This is something the player's going to have to adjust to. You can't put your hands on them now. And if they want to, they can call that on any play.
Fresh 35 after the foul. And Pitt plays it at side court with Ramon on the point. And there's a three by Ramon. Rebound cleared by Robertson. Auburn wants to run. They get it to Barber, and there'll be an intentional foul. Let's see if Barber's okay. Grabs his back and his hamstring as he comes away.
You're gonna look at the Ramon's three-point shooter. Bounces long. That'll usually start a fast break. Quantes Robertson does a wonderful job of getting it down. And they call the intentional foul, and it looked to me like Ramon was going for the ball.
Two free throws for Barber.
This young man needs to spend a lot of time in the gym getting this thing down because he is going to be a guy that's going to go to the free throw line a lot. Shooting only 45% from the line.
Second free throw is good by Barber, and Auburn will play the ball at side court.
You know, his shot doesn't look bad. You know, you talk about technique, they say something wrong. Generally, this situation is mostly a mental thing. I tell you, confidence is such a factor in this game. Standing up there, you against the world.
Barber now with 17 points in the game as Auburn plays the ball in at the end line. Tigers have cut it back to 9 after trailing by 14. Big possession for Auburn here.
Yeah, they need to get Josh Dollar back in this game. They tried to then and got the ball was thrown away.
Good play by Ramon. Ramon brings it up to Cook very quickly. Ramon working a lot at the point here in the second half as Jamie Dixon trying some fresh combinations with his team, working Biggs down on the baseline and Ramon out of the point.
Well, you know, they have not got Mike Cook involved in the game again. They need to get him, but he will make a pass when he doesn't need to, and that was an example of it right there.
Well, Cook threw it to the press row that time, and the turnover will give it back to Auburn again, trailing by 9.
When you have 9 players that can get the job done for you, that makes everybody play hard. If you don't, you're going to be over there on the bench, and Jamie Dixon does a good job of game management, of handling his guys in and out with play and how hard they play. And that's a good example. He took Mike Cook out for a very ill-advised pass.
Beals checks in as Cook gets a rest. There's Robertson for Auburn. They throw it up for Barber, and Barber's fouled in the lane by Graves.
Well, if you want to know what happened here, they did the high screen and the roll and got a mismatch and got a wide-open shot.
For Rodney Barber, we'll shoot 1 plus a bonus when we come back. Pittsburgh leads Auburn by 9.
Don't have the time to make the drive to the Carpets of Dalton campus? Then why not let the campus come to you? Just call this number. The world's largest floor covering store allows you to choose from an unlimited amount of selections right over the phone. Floor coverings for every room, the best names in carpeting and area rugs, tiles, laminates, vinyl, you name it. And you won't find lower prices on this quality anywhere. No answering machines, no telemarketers. You'll talk to lifelong employees of the campus. Discover the Carpets of Dalton campus in the privacy of your home right over the phone.
Tune in for Sports Night weeknights on CSS.
I'm not surprised that he did this. I'm really only surprised that it took him this long to get a start.
And I think he's right in what he's saying, but I just don't think it behooves him to say it.
We've got more questions than answers right now, so stay tuned. They'll all be answered eventually.
I told you this guy is a good coach.
Sports Night. No other party has a guest list like ours. Weeknights at 6 and 11 Eastern, only on CSS. And don't miss the best of Sports Night on CSS On Demand. Available in select markets.
8 of the world's top light heavyweights face off at Gulfstream Park December 14th in the first of a 5-fight elimination series that will crown a new IBA champion. Who will have the heart, the will, the drive and courage to remain standing and be crowned the next king of the ring? The race to the title begins December 14th at Gulfstream Park. Don't miss Rumble in the Park. Tickets available through Ticketmaster. It's not a battle, it's a war.
Well, the Auburn Tigers have scored 5 in a row to cut a 14-point lead down to 9, and they'll be at the free throw line when we resume action here, Pittsburgh and Auburn. You can catch live college hoops tonight on CSS. 19th-ranked Maryland takes on Notre Dame at 6:30. 7:52 to go here, Sonny.
Maryland's going to be a very good basketball team to deal with. I didn't expect them to be what they are right now. They're playing extremely well. They're a great team to watch.
Fun team to watch. They really are. Another team in that league, North Carolina, a team that's growing fast, and that's another very young team, too.
I tell you, this Wright kid out of Nashville, Tennessee, is playing unbelievable for them. I've seen a freshman come in and do that type of thing in a long time.
Here's Barber to shoot 1 plus a bonus for Auburn. And it rattles off the side of the rim, and again, Auburn misses the front end of the 1-1. All tipped out of bounds as Pittsburgh tried to set up Ramon on the far side.
You know, Pittsburgh's been living with a 3-ball out of a timeout. Let's see if they change up and go down inside a little bit, because they haven't been involving inside players in the play very much.
We got both the big guys, Kendall and Gray, back in the game now.
And I don't know that Kendall has hit a field goal off of a pass yet.
Ramon tries to work it on the right side.
They're taking time off the clock, basically what they do before they shoot, with 14 seconds left on the clock.
Fields trying to work, gets it away. Ramon thought about the 3. There's Fields for 3, and Fields can't make it go, but Kendall's there for the backside rebound, and they'll set up again.
And they'll run time off. And they're very good at controlling the tempo. Auburn not able to create points off the defense with them under control of the half-court offense the way they are right now. There's the man they're looking for.
Ramon for 3. Rattles around, no good, but Kendall tips it up and in.
Well, we talked about Kendall not scoring. Well, he ended up doing it then. He was 0 for 4 before that, and he gets a second chance opportunity and knocks it down. That's what he does for his team, the little things.
Pittsburgh again by 11. The Panthers really haven't been challenged this year deep into a second half. And the layup will not fall for Auburn. Josh Dollard, wanting a foul, can't get it. And here's Pittsburgh back again. There's Graves driving baseline away to Gray. Gray works inside, has it knocked free, and he's fouled. Josh Dollard is a frustrated man right now, and he better be careful.
Josh has not been involved in the game as much offensively in the second half. That sometimes creates frustration. They need to get him involved just a little bit, and he did foul. Anytime you swing down like that, generally if you get the ball, you got a serious problem whether they're going to call a foul or not.
I think Dollard's frustration was feeling that he was fouled on the other end. So, but as you mentioned, he's a sophomore and hasn't played a lot this year. And now he's going to get some bench time for Jeff Lebo.
This is Gray's fifth double-double of the year right now. It shows you what he means to this basketball team and why he's on everybody's All-American list and why this place is full of pro scouts today.
That's five double-doubles in eight games for Aaron Gray as we see substitution by both teams.
And he takes him out right now. He's got that double-double that he needed, and he's had a wonderful game. He really has.
Six out of seven at the line for the big man as well. Pass inside. Barber lays it up and in. Corbotany Barber, another basket for the Tigers. He's got 19.
The high pick and roll has been good for Auburn. They either got some baskets out of it or they've been able to go to the free throw line.
Panthers lead back at 11 now. Auburn needing turnovers. Pittsburgh bleeding that clock. Working it around to Kendall. Now they'll face the basket.
They're a very patient basketball team.
Seven to shoot as they go up. No good. There's Barber with a rebound for Auburn.
Great. Great job of rebounding. Very athletic rebound. A very athletic basket by Corbotany Barber on the last time down the floor.
Barber working against Kendall as Pitt stays in that man-to-man.
They're backing off Reed. He's going to have to make a pass.
And Reed hits a three.
It sounded like a coach in, didn't it?
Yelling for him to shoot over there. First three for the freshman, Dwayne Reed. Jeff Lebo gets a 30-second timeout.
Well, if that young man becomes a three-point shooter, look, they back way off, and he's got to take that shot. He's got to make them pay. He's got to make them guard him so he opens up other people.
He's had a confidence problem, according to those around the Auburn basketball program. They think he can be a very fine point guard, but his productivity when Robertson is not in the game goes way down. So, as a result, Robertson stays in and plays two guard most of the time when Reed is in. And when that happens, they're very productive. But as a result, Robertson's averaging about 37 minutes a game. And Jeff Lebo doesn't want that to continue.
You know, he had a great high school career in a very tough league in Texas. The guy is quick as a cat, and he's just been thrown to the fire because they got to play young players. He's got 22 steals this season. Here's a guy that can be a real basketball, a real help, and he's got Southeastern Conference talent written all over him, I think.
You know, Jeff Lebo scheduled Oklahoma State, Wisconsin, this game with Pittsburgh. He is trying to get these young players tempered as fast as he can before the SEC season starts.
Yeah, this is a very tough schedule. Got Texas A&M coming in next. South Alabama, another outstanding basketball team coming in here next week.
Auburn picking up the intensity defensively, but Fields handling it as they run it down under 20 again, down toward 15 on the clock. Fields going to try a three. No good. Rebound on the floor and saved by Ramon, but Ramon... was he out of bounds?
I think he touched the line.
Yeah. Ramon was out of bounds before he controlled the ball. So Auburn with a chance to cut it inside of 10 here if the Tigers can continue this run.
The tempo makes you think the game is over because everybody's kind of dead. But the game is not over. The high pick and roll has been good. There's another high pick and roll which should have opened up something on the post.
Reed working with Barber. Can't get it to Barber. They come back to Talbert. He'll try a three. Off the rim, no good, and there's the rebound inside. And Ramon all over the floor right now
for
the Pittsburgh Panthers.
Ramon can do a lot of things. He can play the point. He can play the second guard. He's an outstanding three-point shooter, as you're going to see him right now. I thought he'd be taking one right there. They're looking for him.
They want it under 15 seconds when they take the shot. Jamie Dixon really wanted them to run those sets. And now they go under 15. And down under 10 before we have a whistle. And a 30-second timeout call by Jamie Dixon.
I think that's a good timeout because they did not get into their play quick enough. When you run that thing down under 10, you got it outside, you don't even have the floor space up properly, and they didn't then. He needed to call a timeout there. That's good coaching.
You know, Pittsburgh's a team, Sonny, that really hasn't been challenged inside the last 5 minutes of a game this year. Their toughest opponent, probably Florida State so far. They beat them by 22. They had a little difficulty the other night at home, but they have put everybody away with 8 or 9 minutes to go in the game. This is the first time anybody's had a chance to get inside a 10 against a
Well, I tell you what, if you're going to deal with this basketball team, you've got to knock down threes outside. And they just have not been able to, Auburn just hadn't been able to do that. I saw a game with Pittsburgh and Robert Morris. Robert Morris was able to knock down some threes and open up some inside play. And I think that that's the only difference in this game right now is Auburn hadn't been able to knock down that three ball.
For Josh Dollard, his double-double is the first of his career. He's on the bench now, though, as we're down to 3 seconds to shoot. Ramon is going to get it up, but it does not draw iron. That'll be a shot clock violation, or should be. And it is a shot clock violation. Auburn will play it at the end line.
Auburn needs to get a good look at the basket this time with a well-designed play. Dollard coming back into the basketball. They need to get him involved in. Here's a guy that plays with high energy when good things are happening for him.
Dollard is in with 4 fouls.
Yeah.
Somebody's going to have to go out eventually. I don't think Jamie Dixon's going to let him play with 6.
Well, I don't think so, and they get that taken care of. And we just had a graphic showing the three-point shooting. Eight threes by the Pittsburgh Panthers today.
Archie Meaway finally goes to the bench, so Auburn with both Barber and Dollard on the floor right now. There's Dollard handling on the high post.
There's a pick and roll that's been so good for him.
And they got a little too far under the goal.
I think there was a push that made that happen.
Our Ramon, I believe, touched the ball while standing on the baseline. So no foul was called there, but Ramon called for out of bounds. Auburn still 25 to shoot. Auburn trying to work that high post again. And nothing there this time. It's Pittsburgh in the man-to-man, but sagging back inside. And there's Kendall with a foul on Dollard as Dollard tried to make a move.
Well, I thought with Dollard coming off the bench, they would try to get him involved. And that was a play set up for Josh Dollard, trying to get him a screen out high. The guy's a good outside shooter.
Dollard will shoot the 1-1 to try to pull Auburn inside of 10 when we come back.
Beginning this January, watch live PGA Tour coverage every week on the Golf Channel. Watch live primetime coverage of the Mercedes-Benz Championship.
Balance their checkbooks. I don't think 10-year-olds have checkbooks. No checkbooks, no inboxes, no employers, just wild imaginations. I have to go listen to some emo.
Brunch. $30.
Hey, that's okay, Wendy. That was a good carry. You're still the man. You're the man.
Latte. $4.
Ooh, shake it off, Johnny. Rub some dirt on it.
New piano. $3,000.
All right, guys. They're not saying boo. They're saying movers.
Supporting your team. Priceless.
Sorry, Bobby. You still got the best arm in the neighborhood.
There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard.
This is decaf, right?
Even uses pro footage, so you'll see the techniques applied in real games from around the globe. Plus, you'll learn from Hall of Famer Nancy Lieberman and Jason Kidd. If your goal is to play at the next level or just plain win, get the entire Better Basketball series, put in the sweat, and then reap the rewards. Learn more about all 7 DVDs from BetterBasketball.com or call us at 1-800-BETTER-BEAT. If you buy 6 of the videos, the 7th is free. Order now at BetterBasketball.com.
Under 4 minutes to go here. The Auburn Tigers right back in this game. And, Sonny, the Pittsburgh Panthers take the crowd out of the game with these half-court sets. But Auburn has chopped this 14-point lead down to 8 and a chance to cut it further with Josh Dollard at the free throw line. This game is far from over.
It is far from over. Just a couple of good things happen for the Tigers. They're right back in it, and if they can get the game somehow to change the speeds up a little bit and get a little bit different tempo, they'll be okay. They're going to have to do it with their defense. And now, usually out of a timeout, Jeff Lebo generally makes good changes with his teams, and good things happen.
Aaron Gray has checked back in, so the big lineup back for the Pittsburgh Panthers is Dollard, set to shoot a 1-1. Knocks down the first one.
Very, very important.
He cuts it to seven. Chance to knock it down to six. Second one rattles out. Rebound goes to the floor, but Ramon is there again to claim it. Ramon has been the MVP for Pittsburgh this afternoon.
Really good blockouts by the Panthers.
They go straight to Gray, back to Ramon. Auburn trying to turn up the defensive pressure. There's the outside shot. They went a little quicker that time, and Auburn's going to get a foul on Gray. And on Aaron Gray, that's number four.
That's a big foul right there. This game is not over. The crowd needs to realize that and get back into this game.
That's team foul number 10, so Auburn shooting the double bonus from now on free throws as well, and the Tigers still with a foul to give. They've committed only five, so Auburn needing to hit the free throws now. It'll be the freshman, Dwayne Reed, at the line.
These are big free throws for the freshman to make, and in being a point guard, if you can knock down free throws, it energizes your basketball team. It looks good up there.
First one up and good for Dwayne Reed. Shut up. And Reed knocks them both down.
Knocks them both. We got a game. We got a game.
Reed four out of four from the free throw line. Auburn going to full court pressure. Tonight's game between Pittsburgh and Auburn is presented by the Cochran Firm.
Crowds in the game, players energized defensively, and it's an 8-0 run by the Auburn Tigers. They got to get a stop.
There's a drive inside, rattles off, and the rebound claimed by Dollard. Auburn with a chance to cut it closer. It's a 5-point game.
Got a little speed back into the game.
Drive by Robertson, nothing there. Here's Dollard. Thought about a three and walked.
Josh cannot let frustration keep him from having a great game. He's had a great basketball game up to this point.
His first inclination, Sonny, was to shoot the three. He saw the opening, but shuffled the feet before he could put the ball on the floor.
Well, a big guy, he'll create a lot of hesitation with that wingspan that he has. Aaron Gray has a great wingspan.
Under 3 minutes to go, 5-point game. There's Reed out pressing, and over and back is going to be the call on Pittsburgh. As Fields hit the line.
Tremendous defensive pressure will create turnovers, and it's happened today.
That's a true freshman, Dwayne Reed, forcing Fields to take a step back. As you see on the replay, he got his hand on the ball and just the heel barely touching the line. The call on the over and back. That was very close.
Well, they need to get the high pick and roll involving Barber and Dollar in the game. There's the high pick and a good roll and the feel. That should get you something.
Kendall was there on the backside. They didn't want to throw it in there. Here's Talbert with a drive. Layup up and in by Frank Talbert.
Now
he's got 8 points. It's a 3-point game.
That's called creating a shot. Frank Talbert is very good at that.
Ramon trying to bring it up against pressure from Robertson. Auburn looked like they're going to trap, but they didn't. And here's Ramon driving all the way down, lays it up and in. Ramon has had a tremendous game on the floor. And shooting the ball for the Pittsburgh Panthers.
What a tremendous drive to the basket. Did not get a lot of help out of the low post people rotating on defense there to help out on that drive.
There's Talbert fouled by Cook. Frank Talbert will go to the line to shoot two as Mike Cook picks up the foul. That'll be his third.
You know, Frank Talbert gives me the impression of a guy that wants the ball late in the game. He wants the basketball. You got to have a player like that to give you that offensive leadership that you need.
Pittsburgh led it by 14 midway through the second half. Auburn has cut it to three. Right now it's a 5-point margin with Talbert shooting two. And the first one rattles off.
Free throws are so very important now. Points with the clock dead can do so much for you inside 3 minutes. 2:03 left in the game.
Tigers have struggled at the line. Second free throw is up and good by Talbert, and it's a 4-point game.
4-point game, full court press, running on defense.
And Kendall, let's see what the call is. Did they get the timeout? I think Pittsburgh got the timeout.
Timeout's called from the bench, and I think that was good because they were in trouble. Tremendous job of defensive pressure by the Tigers. They fronted. on the inbounds and then went straight man for man, was doing a good job of pressure.
Yeah, I think the man for man surprised Pittsburgh on the inbounds play there.
Yes. Well, they do a Auburn does a very good job, as does Pittsburgh, in alternating the defenses up when you're pressing.
Foul situation interesting here. Auburn is shooting the double bonus, while the Tigers have a foul to give on the floor. Well, they've only committed five here in the second half.
Well, when you're living by the three-point shot, as Pittsburgh has done, you're not going to go to the free throw line a lot. But when you are driving the ball to the basket as the Tigers do, you're going to go more.
Auburn 11 for 19. And they wish they had shot a better percentage. That's been an Achilles heel for these Auburn Tigers.
Pittsburgh does a great job of shooting their free throws, that's for sure.
80% for the Panthers. Kendall bluffs the baseball throw and gets it into Gray, who is a great free throw shooter, and Auburn kicks it out of bounds. Dollard. Again, Pittsburgh will play at the end line, but they can't move at the end line this time.
No, but the reason they're running Gray deep is because he can look over the traps. And they run him in there, and that makes it very, very difficult for them to throw it out of the trap. They're taking him out of the game because of it's going to be offense-defense right now because of his foul trouble.
So Kendall is in. Kendall motioning that he'd like to go deep. They get it in, and Auburn knocks it out again. Frank Talbert and Josh Dollard making it a very small window. 2 seconds ran off the clock.
Actually, they might take Gray out because of ball handling. Get some ball handlers in.
We're going to get a foul called on Talbert.
Yes.
Against Antonio Graves. No shots here. That'll be a foul on the floor. Team foul number 6 against Auburn. And Talbert's third. So Pittsburgh will be shooting on future fouls.
That was a good call. Frank was being a little bit too aggressive there. But Frank wants to win. He gives great, great effort.
We're set for the inbounds play, as we also are set to go under 2 minutes in a 4-point game. Inbounds to Ramon. And Ramon gets it over the timeline. He's double teamed there. Loose ball. And who comes out? Auburn comes out with it. It's Dollard. And we have a call on the floor. Let's see what the call is.
The call is on Kendall. Kendall reaching in while the ball's on the floor and committing a foul.
Foul on Kendall will be his fourth, and Auburn will be shooting two.
Look at the effort now by both ball clubs on the floor. Tremendous job by Quantes Robinson also. Kendall just foul curled on the reach in.
Dollard got up around the shoulder, and Dollard will shoot two. First free throw is good, and it's a 3-point game.
With 1:53 to go.
It was a 14-point game inside the final 10 minutes, and Auburn, with full court pressure, has rallied here on the home floor.
Yeah, they've done it with defensive pressure has changed the tempo of the game.
Second free throw rims out. Here's Graves trying to come up across the timeline. He does. Under a minute 50 now.
This is not a good position for Antonio Graves. He needs to have, somebody else needs to have the basketball.
They get it away to Ramon, who has had a great game, and there's a foul against Dollard, and Dollard will be disqualified. Seventh team foul on Auburn, fifth on Josh Dollard, and that'll send Ramon to the line. Dollard has played an outstanding game, getting his first start of the year.
This guy has been tremendous. He really, offensively, defensively, and he appears to be a much stronger player than a year ago, and has been much missed during his loss of playing time, let's say.
1-1 for Ramon coming. He is a 75% free throw shooter, as we see Dollard head for the bench after an outstanding effort. And Jeff Lebo there still doing a little coaching.
Well, he should. That was not a good foul.
1-1 up and off the rim. Rebound taken inside by Rasheem Barrett. And Auburn will have a chance to tie here. Trailing by three with 85 seconds.
Auburn needs to get a good look.
Freshman Reed. Guarded by Kendall, and there's a walk on Talbert. Thought about the three-pointer and again took the extra step.
Well, he wants it so bad. He just needs to pay a little bit more within himself and play under control, because he is a guy that can win a game for you, because he's not afraid to try anything.
Aaron Gray checks back in now for Pittsburgh, and they've got the two big guys in. Gray and Kendall.
This is a big possession for both teams right here, defensively and offensively.
Auburn had a chance to tie, did not get a shot away. And they get the ball in to Gray, and Gray gets it back to his guard. And Fields will set things up. Fields, right by Robertson. Kendall double teamed, and they're going to foul Kendall as they come up and try to knock the ball free. Jeff Lebo's very upset.
I don't believe that they wanted that foul at that time. Kendall is going to the line, and he's a 79% free throw shooter. The one guy on the team, that other than the Fields, that you would not want on the line.
Foul was on Robertson. That is his fourth for Auburn. 68 seconds to go as Kendall shoots one plus the bonus, and he missed it. And a rebound is tipped up by Gray, and he puts it up and in.
Oh, big time rebound.
Them out of their house. Well, that's when things get really interesting.
Online predators know what they're doing. Do you?
And for the swivel sweeper.
Oh my God, I just love this little sweeper.
Very lightweight, very easy to maneuver.
The swivel action makes it easy.
But it's not like a vacuum cleaner where you have to plug it into the wall.
This is small, it's convenient, it's quiet, it's wonderful.
Well, it works and it's lightweight. That's the best part about it. It
weighs no more than a regular broom.
And they're having more fun cleaning than I've ever seen.
Yeah.
It's small enough to go through the furniture.
It works. It's easy.
It went and glided right over it, and it came right up.
We have a vacuum, and then we have a regular broom for the kitchen. This replaces both.
If you're busy and you have no time, this is definitely the product.
We love our swivel sweeper.
I give it two thumbs up.
It really is a product that I think everybody should have.
Anthony Sullivan here, and we're in sunny Orlando, Florida. And you've just heard from people who love their swivel sweepers. And believe it or not, in less than a year, over 1 million swivel sweepers have been sold. That's right, 1 million sold in less than a year. But if you want to know why the swivel sweeper is sweeping the nation, let me show you how it works. First of all, it operates with a snap-and-go rechargeable battery. It's cordless. It weighs less than 2 pounds. And it swivels 360 degrees to the left and 360 degrees to the right. That's why we call it the swivel sweeper. But it uses what we call quad brush technology. It cleans forwards, but it also cleans backwards. Look at this. Anywhere you go, the swivel sweeper cleans. Even going to the left side, it picks up forwards, backwards, or side to side. The swivel sweeper knows how to do one thing, and that's clean. You can run from the swivel sweeper, but you can't hide. And to empty it, it's easy. Now remember, it weighs 2 pounds, which is about, well, it's lighter than a broom, most brooms, and it's way lighter than a vacuum cleaner. And let's talk about vacuum cleaners. Normally, you have to get it out, you have to plug it in, and it doesn't get underneath your furniture, it doesn't get around your table legs, but the swivel sweeper does.
It's small enough to go through the furniture.
You can get in between the legs of the chairs, and it goes around the corner of the table. It's very versatile.
Watch this. Out in the open, it performs like a pro. From crumbs to the big stuff, it picks it up. Now watch this. I've seen paper clips damage even the most expensive vacuum cleaners, but not with the swivel sweeper. Plus, its ultra-low profile design gets underneath furniture, around table legs, and remember, it cleans forwards, backwards, and side to side.
With wheels, you can only go one direction at a time. With the sliders, you can go everywhere.
It moves in every direction that you want it to. You don't have to pick.
If either team had shot free throws well, it would have been decided a while back. Here's Robertson with the second free throw. This one's up, rattles in for Quantes Robertson. He has 5 in the game. And it's a 4-point game. Baseball pass, the run out. Fields is going to lay it up and in. Nice pass by Kendall.
Defensive mistake by the freshman. Not a bad shot. Get a shot quickly.
Under 30 seconds. There's the drive by Robertson. Has it blocked by Gray. And Pittsburgh comes away with it. Loose ball. And there's a foul on the baseline. And let's see if there's an injury down there as well. As And the Panthers went to the floor very hard, Antonio Graves. Aaron Gray just stuffed that shot inside.
Yeah, and also that puts him on a line to shoot two. The bonus is in effect.
Still hadn't put up who the foul was against, but it will be Graves shooting two.
It was still Frank Calder.
Okay. And he misses the first one.
I tell you, this has not been pretty from the free throw line for either ball club today.
Barber goes out, and the three-point shooter Miaway checks in, and Gray will go out. And they'll put Keith Benjamin in for defensive purposes now for Pittsburgh. Second free throw by Graves is up and good. Well, eventually somebody had to hit one. 73-66. There's a drive by Talbert. He misses the layup, a little out of control as he came in there. Pittsburgh going to run out now. Graves going to try to dribble things out as we come down to 10 seconds in the game. And there's a foul on Auburn on the base on the sideline.
Well, one thing that Pittsburgh was able to do late in the ball game, Auburn did a good job of getting back into the game with defensive pressure. The Panthers started throwing the ball long instead of keeping it down in backcourt, and that helped out a lot. Got a layup out of it once and got some foul trouble out of it in the other court.
Graves again misses the free throw. He'll have the bonus.
Well, this has not been pretty from the free throw line for either ball club.
Second one by Graves will go down.
Well, he has a great looking shot.
And here's Auburn in the closing seconds. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound taken by Fields, and he'll dribble things out now for the Pittsburgh Panthers, and the Panthers go to 8-0. A hard-fought victory for Pittsburgh here as they overcome Auburn. A late run by the Auburn Tigers pulls Auburn within three. The Pittsburgh able to handle the ball and shoot it down the stretch, Sonny. And they did enough down the stretch to pull out a road victory, their first victory on the road this year.
A lot of good things, but hey, didn't get the win. Needed a win.
Jeff Lebo has some things he can build on here for his Auburn team. Pittsburgh goes home. They protect their number two ranking with their first trip on the road. For my partner, Sonny Smith, this is Paul Allen saying so long from Beard East Memorial Coliseum in Auburn, Alabama. Your final score, Pittsburgh 74, Auburn 66.
Tonight on CSS, tune in at 6:30 Eastern for live NCAA college basketball as Maryland takes on Notre Dame. Stay tuned for Talkin' Football at 8:30. Then at 9, catch college football action in the ACC Championship game. Make your Saturday nights more exciting with championship boxing on CSS. Get in the ring for bouts featuring high-profile fighters every Saturday at
the elbow hit, but the question is, was the ball on the way out?
And when does an elbow equal? Is an elbow equal a knee? The elbow's down now. If that's the case, then that should not be a fumble. At this angle here, though, you cannot see the football. That's a bad angle to kind of see it. You might get a better one here. This is getting tackled, Casey Hampton. His elbow looks like it touches first before his knee right there. But again, you can't see if the football has come out. Right now, obviously, the football is out. When his back is turned, you can't see. It's a tough angle. They need conclusive evidence to turn this football call.
Terry McCauley is under the hoodie there. One of the new points of emphasis this year regarding replay, he's got 1 minute. And they say if he stays under any longer than 1 minute, then most likely the call is going to be overturned from what was called in the field.
So that's not good news if you're a Bucs fan then. That's too bad for the Bucs because finally in this game, it was the first time that they've actually started establishing a drive. Mm-hmm. They were mixing things up. Instead of just dropping back straight and letting the Steelers pin their ears back,
right,
they moved the pocket. They got Gradkowski on the perimeter. Short set drop. They threw a quick completion to Joey Galley, really getting this thing going. And the screenplay I thought was a great call. Try to soften up this pass rush by the Steelers.
And the Buccaneers finally got a decent week of rest and practice after having three games in 11 days something that John Gruden pointed out in the beginning of the season. Hey, what kind of schedule is this?
That's really interesting. You know, we asked him, had this been a very difficult year for them in terms of calling football plays on offense? Mm-hmm. And he says it has, but he said the biggest reason was this schedule. He said, first, you got to play three games in 11 days versus very tough opponents. And, it, you know, it's just it's murdered them.
After you, the runner's right elbow was down prior to losing control of the football. The ball will be placed at the 48-yard line, second down.
So Tampa Bay retains possession. In other words, the elbow is the same as a knee. He was down.
That's a big break for the Tampa Bay Bucks. A good challenge by John Gruden to kind of try to keep this momentum going forward. You'll see it right here again. His elbow's down right now. So as of right now,
the play is dead.
And they'll spot the ball where his elbow touched. First down for the Bucks.
You saw Larry Foote come in there late and punch it out. But it was a done deal, second and one. And now there could be some discussion as to time on the clock or the spot of the ball. Probably will reset it and we'll go.
So important to Bucks here, try to keep this momentum, keep getting positive plays to make these third downs more manageable.
Second down and one, and there's movement.
False start, offense, number 24. 5-yard penalty, second down.
See, it was too much excitement for Cadillac.
Right, you know. And going back to what we talked about, this schedule right here, you see coming into this season, the Bucks have the third toughest schedule. And we asked Gruden, he said, look, it's been hard with rookies playing in this offense, a rookie quarterback calling plays, but the hardest thing has been the schedule we played. You look at the defenses this team has had to play this year, Baltimore, Carolina twice, New York healthy, Philadelphia, Dallas last week. Doesn't get any easier today versus Pittsburgh.
They'll go back to the ground. Williams looking for the corner, almost got it.
And again, you're talking more about that schedule. They were going to play eight teams this year. That's half of their games against teams that were in the playoffs last year. That's tough. And I think when you factor in the fact that they had to play three games in 11 days, that is basically no time on offense or defense to game plan for that. It makes it so much harder when you have a rookie quarterback who has to game plan. When he gets one solid day to prepare for teams like that, it makes it tough no matter who you are. It doesn't matter if you're John Elway.
Third and one, Allstott, and of course, Allstott pounds his way through, gets up in the air.
Mike. Once they get into short yard situations, this guy, Mike Allstott, is going to get on the field no matter what. Here you see in the short yards, they're going to run Allstott here to the left. They get a surge up front to get this yard. Mike Allstott means so much to this offense, especially in short yard situations. And I'll tell you what, if you're a Tampa Bay Buccaneers fan, you want Mike Allstott to get a rushing touchdown this game. When he does that versus AFC opponents, their team is 11-0.
First down, Buccaneers. Play action pass. Looks for the deep out. It's not there. Checks it down. That's the big tight end, Anthony Beck. And Beck has at least eight. Call it nine. Fox football coverage doesn't end when the games are over. Afterwards, stick around for the OT live from New York, where Kurt, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy bring you interviews, highlights, and a look ahead to next week's action. That's the OT coming up on Fox.
Gradkowski so far on this drive looks a lot more comfortable. He's taking what the defense is giving them, throwing checkdowns, keeping the ball going forward.
Second down and one, Allstott again. Not much.
You know, and it's so important that the Bucs are able to establish the run early in downs, first and second down, or throw quick completions, because when the Tampa Bay Buccaneers face third and more than six, they're worst in the NFL in conversions. They've only converted 18% of plays at their third and six, and it's just impossible to score points, get drives established. We've seen them, this is the best job they've done so far this game, running the football, getting Gradkowski on the perimeter, short sets. You see right here the play selection, a lot of balance. 10 passes, 10 rushes, doing a good job mixing it up, and now here you are in a very manageable third and one.
Allstott alone in the backfield. There's the toss to Clayton. He's got a head up of speed, and Clayton lowers his head, gets the first down.
And not necessarily the guy you thought would get the football on a third and one. Mike Allstott lines up, and I guarantee everybody on defense was pointing to him, but you're going to get Clayton coming from this side. He's going to take a sweep play. It just uses blockers in front of him. He gets Allstott leading the way. Michael Clayton able to kind of outflank anything coming inside. It just gets enough for the first down to keep these chains moving. going deep into the playbook for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers to find ways to give this defense different looks, regardless whether it's first down or third and one.
Clayton has been very quiet this year, only one touchdown in the last 24 games. And that's Williams, he's grinding it inside. And the gang tackle there by the Steeler defense.
I'll tell you what, and it's such a task for any team to try to run against this 3-4 defense the Pittsburgh Steelers use. And basically, it all starts up front in the middle at nose guard. Casey Hampton, number 98, weighs 325 pounds. He's one of those guys that demands double teams all across the line. And that's something that the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are going to have to do a good job of today, is getting fits, getting double teams on the inside to try to allow for running lanes for Cadillac Williams.
Hampton checks out on the second down and seven. The late throw, and it's turned down. Galloway couldn't hold on. And when you look at the Buccaneers on paper from the perimeter side, they've got one guy that you've got to worry about this year, and that's that man, not that man, but Joey Galloway.
Absolutely. Joey Galloway runs his 40 times a small bit faster than John Gruden, but Joey Galloway on the football field at all times is a threat, no matter where he lines up. He's a threat deep. I'll tell you what, Gronkowski's had problems getting the ball to him this year. He runs so fast. After all these years, Galloway's had. I'll tell you what, Troy Aikman had those same problems in Dallas. This guy's fast. The Steelers have to know where he is at all times.
Movement by the Steelers. Rodney Bailey jump. Let's see if he was pulled off.
Prior to any contact on the field, Tampa Bay called and requested their first team timeout.
Okay, so Bailey, you're safe. Timeout, Buccaneers.
Turn left. Turn clockwise. Over. Turn under. Turn left at intersection. Destination ahead.
Navigate your holidays. Now, for a limited time, buy or lease a specially equipped Cadillac, and we'll pay for the navigation system. Season's best from Cadillac.
I think I want to, like, do something.
Like what?
Fight.
People are going to think you've gone crazy.
If two athletes from different eras could actually compete against one another, who would come out on top?
Then you don't have to do it.
Yeah, well, I think I do.
This Christmas.
It's been a long time since I've seen a fight.
The only way to get respect is to earn it.
There's nothing more to prove, Pop.
Rocky Balboa.
I gotta go out the way I gotta go.
Rated PG. In theaters everywhere this Christmas.
Unstoppable. Sasha Cohen is. So is her Citizen Echo Drive. Fueled by light, it never needs a battery. It's unstoppable. Just like the people who wear it. Citizen Echo Drive watches. Unstoppable.
Don't miss the Billboard Music Awards with the artists you've made number one, with performances by Fergie, The Killers, Gwen Stefani, Mary J. Blige, Ludacris with Pharrell and Young Jeezy, Janet Jackson, and more. The Billboard Music Awards at 8, 7 Central tomorrow on Fox.
Don't know why there's no sun up in the sky, stormy weather, since my man and I ain't together. Keeps raining all the time.
The dream is back. American Idol returns this January on Fox.
Let's see if you can tell John Gruden is upset about Gronkowski calling that timeout.
Well, I think he was upset with him in terms of getting up to the line of scrimmage. I think he felt he was taking his time. He wants him, I think, to quicken up the tempo a little bit, get the guys set, pick up pace on offense.
I need to pick it up here at third and seven. Buccaneers pointing out blitz. Steelers bring it. Two secondary men and a sack from the backside.
And again, we talked about it. When any time the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are going to get into a third and six or longer, the Pittsburgh Steelers are going to pin their ears back, and they bring different guys from different angles. But one thing they do is a great job covering. Ike Hilliard not open up top on the screen. Joey Porter runs under him. To this side, they cloud this side, which means they have safety help on all the receivers to that side of the field. There's nowhere to go for Gronkowski. He ends up tripping, forces the sack, and now another punt. That stalled their best drive so far in this football game.
Brett Kiesel is there for the sack, and Gronkowski going up against one of the architects of defense, Dick LeBeau. He can mess with even the veteran quarterback's heads.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And that punt rolls into the end zone. It'll be a touchback going the other way. Well, tonight, college football's greatest teams find out who they will play in college football's greatest game. It's a live primetime special that you can only see on Fox, the All-State BCS Selection Show. Follows our football coverage tonight on Fox. And I know one team that will slide down a few ranks. Those USC Trojans. Boy, that's sad, isn't it?
Especially coming from someone who went to UCLA.
I
know that means you're really upset.
To have a chance for a national championship and to see it just melt away like that. My heart aches.
Yeah.
Pump and go. It's not there. Roethlisberger dumps it down. It's complete to Parker. And Parker with a great pickup. He's close to midfield. Driven out of bounds by Rondae Barber. We were talking about the BCS standings there. And boy, I love that music in the background. And with the UCLA win last night, SC will most likely drop. And Ohio State will play your alma mater, the Florida Gators.
Well, that's certainly what we're hoping for.
We're hoping
down in Gainesville.
That, right?
That's going to be an interesting discussion tonight. What we see tonight, it's going to cause a lot of confusion, a lot of uproar regardless. Speaking of Buckeyes, Santonio Holmes lining up at the X spot on offense.
25 yards by Parker. Play action. It's not there. Roethlisberger trying to get out and run and can't quite do it. Greg Spires. And I think Roethlisberger is hurt. And Spires is definitely hurt.
Well, Roethlisberger getting up slowly. Spires still laying on the ground. Ooh. That would be a big blow to the Tampa Bay defense. If Spires were to be injured, you're going to see Roethlisberger here on a play fake. Trying to step up. He's not able to.
Lance Armstrong for Bristol-Myers Squibb.
Remember me, cancer? You gave me less than a 50-50 chance to live. You made me suffer. My mom, too. But you made me smarter and more determined and a believer in miracles. Remember me, cancer? You made me what I am today.
Your will, our medicines. Together, we can fight the serious diseases. Bristol-Myers Squibb. Together, we can prevail.
No, I understand, sir. The problem is I don't have access to your records.
Oh boy, okay. That's a really great question. I don't have the answer with me.
No, you need to do that in person. It's on a different system.
You sure you're a customer?
It's not the 6500.
Nope.
But I ordered the 6500.
Yeah, that's not what this says.
What can people do with the right software?
Yes, ma'am. I've got all of your records in front of me. I can take care of it from here.
For starters, keep the customer happy.
Fell into the gap, they rockin' the hood. Seen peace in the streets when I stopped in the hood. We gon' keep it alive like hip-hop in the hood. It's good when love don't stop in the hood. It's a celebration like Dave Chef Pitbull. Hugs to the fam, kisses under the mistle. So when I flow, feel the power to rap ass. People giving me love, I'm seeing the gap ass. Gifted like Christmas, so I love to rap. We gon' give it to the world, peace, love, and gap. Give it to the world, peace, love, and gap. We gon' give it to the world, peace, love, and gap.
Next week on Fox, it begins at 12 p.m. Eastern with the pregame show. Then it's the Falcons and the Buccaneers, the Eagles and the Redskins, or the Giants and the Panthers, or the Minnesota Vikings and the Detroit Lions. Check your local listings for the game in your area. So Roethlisberger appears to be okay. You can see his numbers there on the day.
He's done a very good job today so far operating and taking what the defense has given him. The only blemish on that record there is just the one interception. Aside from that, he's played lights out.
What a season he has had off the field. Started off with that motorcycle accident, then the appendectomy. And the 9 sacks last week against Baltimore didn't help the health issue.
Give you nightmares all week.
Second down and 9, play action. Pressure again. He's out of the pocket, looking deep, and it's caught. And that's another Steeler first down. Nate Washington again. And that was one of the things that Nate Washington had to improve on coming from Roethlisberger. The hard catch he can make, but it's the easy one, losing the focus on those easier catches.
Right, absolutely. They joke all the time. They say, look, you could have 6 more touchdowns if you just catch the easy passes. And Nate Washington there does a good job in the slot. He worked his way to the sideline. You know, and he's got a big weapon. He's got a lot of speed. Defenses have to account for that on the outside, and it's a big test for him today. He hasn't had a lot of experience this year, but so far today, Nate Washington has been a big answer for this Pittsburgh offense.
That's Willie Parker inside. A great story with Nate Washington. He almost wasn't a Pittsburgh Steeler. He was an undrafted free agent, almost signed with Detroit. Detroit calls him up and says, you know what, we've changed our mind. What happened was they made a clerical error. They thought he was another free agent. They got him mixed up. They wanted to cut the other guy. They said no to him. He comes to Pittsburgh and signs. Detroit calls him and says, hey, come on back.
It's too late. Too late.
And good for Pittsburgh
and
right
now. A good
pickup
for Pittsburgh. No question.
Second down and seven. Oh, almost a great catch. Santonio Holmes couldn't quite hang on.
I'll tell you one thing that's pretty interesting. If you watch closely at the way the center, Jeff Hardings for the Pittsburgh Steelers, holds the football when he snaps, he holds it sideways. It's a bit hard to see right here. Normally the football faces this way and that way. What happens is when he snaps it, the point of the ball that Ben Roethlisberger gets, it kind of digs into his thumb. There's an area on his thumb where the ball point always hits. And Ben told us earlier, it drives him crazy every time he gets a snap, but you're not going to change anything. That a guy like Jeff Hardings, how he snaps, a Pro Bowl center like that, you just got to let him do what he does.
11th year in the league, former first round pick with the Detroit Lions back in 96. Blitz comes, they pick up one. And Roethlisberger doing a pretty nice job of getting away from a couple, but he can't avoid the tackle. Dwayne White finally brings him down. And that should be the 2-minute warning here in Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh with an early score hanging on to the 7-0 lead.
If you're done with pushing messes into corners, let the swivel.
Through the holidays, life, liberty, and the pursuit.
The Visa check card. Because money shouldn't slow you down. Life takes faster money. Life takes Visa.
Get used to more action. Download hundreds of movies with AT&T Home Zone. TV with the power of the internet. Another innovation from the new AT&T. Your world delivered.
Stop. Back up. Turn right. Turn right. Straight ahead. Turn left at intersection. Destination ahead.
Navigate your holidays. Now, for a limited time, buy or lease a specially equipped Cadillac and we'll pay for the navigation system. Season's best from Cadillac.
FedEx presents the Air and Ground NFL Players of Week 12. New Orleans' Drew Brees completed 21 of 30 passes for 349 yards and two touchdowns in the Saints' win against the Falcons. Indianapolis' Joseph Addai ran for 171 yards and four touchdowns on 24 carries in the Colts' win against the Eagles. Vote for the FedEx Air and Ground NFL Players of the Week at FedExFootball.com.
This will be 50 yards for Jeff Reed, his first 50-yard attempt of the season. He's got a long of 46. He hit that week 8 against the Denver Broncos.
I think a big play leading up to this field goal on that last third down was Ben Roethlisberger's ability to scramble, try to keep the drive alive and not take a sack, which leaves the football here just beyond the 30, and very makeable field goal right here for Jeff Reed.
Gaki on the hold, nearly blocked. It's up, it's straight, and it's good. 50-yard attempt pads the lead for the Pittsburgh Steelers. The first 50-plus field goal this year for Jeff Reed in a season long.
Well, it looks like this was almost going to be blocked. You're going to see Tampa Bay Buccaneer fly in from the right side. He's able to get it off. He kicks that thing deadly straight. A lot of leg. It's a great kick. Three big points right now. take this 10-0.
Don't forget, coming up next, it's a Visa Halftime Report with Kurt, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy. They'll have all the scores and highlights, plus the Fox Sports ticker. And you know what I want for Christmas?
What do you not?
I want for Jimmy Johnson to say, how about them Bruins?
Tell you what, after last night, you never know. He might say something like that.
Or how about them Gators would be good, too.
How about them Gators, yeah. The job Urban Meyer's done down there in Gainesville. A tough, tough conference in the SEC.
Because I know Troy Aikman is just so happy he doesn't know what to do right now.
There's a lot of Bruins like right. that, I think, right now. It's been six, seven years now.
Well, they didn't get the record. We got the record of 8 in a row, so. 1:56 here in the first half. The Steelers go up 10-0. Another short kick. This will be Cox. Cox going sideways. Great coverage once again by the Steelers special teams. James Harrison hustles down. And some surprises on the day earlier. You look around the league and Arizona with the win over St. Louis. That was in St. Louis, so you know there was some bad blood there with the former Cardinals coming back to town and getting the W. And Green Bay just looked flat against the New York Jets. And Tennessee dropping the Indianapolis Colts 20-17.
Cleveland beating Kansas City with their backup quarterback Anderson playing the majority of that football game.
Gradkowski, 1:51 left, two timeouts. Pittman fumbles and he gets it back.
I'll tell you what, I'm sorry, Ryan, in the big picture right now for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers on a two-minute drive, what's your mindset? Do you want to try to plug down the football field and get some points? It looks like on this drive they're just trying to get a quick-hitting run play to Cadillac Williams, just set this thing up, expecting the Pittsburgh defense to play a lot of big zones, a lot of prevent, not a lot of pressure, which opens up a lot of running lanes for the Bucs. Unfortunately, they get the fumble, but while clock's still ticking down, that's going to stall this Bucs offense.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't look like he ever really got the ball clean. A four wide out look for Tampa Bay. There's the toss and a nice run. Williams, and Williams is out past the 30-yard line.
Cadillac Williams showing you his speed to get yes. to the outside. They run that toss. That's something a lot of people were really excited about when they drafted him last year, was the speed they were going to get on offense, and he shows that on that run.
Running to the right side there, the right guard, Devin Joseph, the first-round pick out of Oklahoma, alongside Jeremy Trueblood, the right tackle, the second-round pick out of Boston College.
They've had a lot of success today running this play. This is the third time they've run it. They've gotten a lot of yards behind two rookies, which is really interesting. We talked to John Gruden about Davin Joseph, the first-round pick from this year out of Oklahoma. They think he's going to be great. They said he might be one of the best O-linemen in Tampa Bay in a long time. They're very excited. Mm-hmm. Jeremy Trueblood's had to play because of Kenyatta Walker early this year going on injured reserve, but he stepped in and done a good job. He was their second-round pick of this year's draft. So it's been interesting having their first and second-round pick play beside each other on an offensive line. And so far today, they've done a good job both playing together, running the football on a tough, tough rush defense for the Pittsburgh Steelers.
You see the third down conversions today. This is a third and inches. They'll go with the sneak, Gradkowski. And he'll definitely have it. Now they got to get up. That's a first down.
It doesn't look like the Buccaneers really are too concerned with that. I think more than anything, that was a big first down to get just to ensure they keep the football and not give it back to Pittsburgh before this first half is over.
Some timeouts up top. A little bit of a half pass, half shovel. But it's Pittman, and Pittman can be about 2 yards short, maybe three of the first down. A timeout is called by Tampa Bay. They'll have one left. Don't forget the Visa Halftime Report coming your way in about 23 seconds. All the scores, highlights, all the action from around the NFL, plus the Fox Sports ticker. And some big-time surprises, as we've already shown you, in the NFL today.
And now that the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are getting close to their own 40-yard line, they're probably starting to think, hey, field goal opportunity maybe here. They have one timeout left. They have an opportunity to try to work the football along the sidelines, get guys out of bounds, hopefully get somewhere close to Pittsburgh's 30-yard line, and give their kicker, Matt Bryan, an opportunity to put some points on the board before going into the locker room here at halftime.
And remember, Bryant hit that 62-yarder versus the Philadelphia Eagles earlier in the year.
He's got a lot of range. If that's the case, then, you know, really, you need to get the football another 20 yards now. Makes it a lot easier on this offense.
Steelers showing pressure inside. Pick up one. Gretkowski on the move. And he'll have the first down. But they may have to burn the final timeout. And they do. Last timeout for Tampa Bay.
Well, you're going to see Alex Smith. He's on the right-hand side, number 81. He's going to be waving his hands on this play as he comes out in his route. He sees himself wide open. There's an area to throw the football. Gradkowski doesn't have time. There's a lot of pressure in his face. He had to shuffle, step up, and just try to get what he could. It's unfortunate because that completion to Alex Smith would have got them close to the Pittsburgh 40-yard line. And as soon as you get inside that area, all of a sudden now you've entered Matt Bryant's range.
Look at Bryant warming up there. Technically, well, depends on who you argue with. Some say it was the second longest field goal in NFL history. Some say it was the third.
I don't understand how it's the third.
I don't
Two
either.
Guys have kicked the second longest field goal.
Gretkowski looking in trouble. Sack.
Well, there's too much pressure here for Aaron Smith. Gretkowski unable to throw this football away, but just going to let the clock bleed, taking it to halftime down 10 points.
Doesn't even try to throw it. And that's the end of the first half. Steelers up 10-0. Visa Halftime Report coming your way after a word from your local Fox station.
Next week on Fox NFL Sunday, the guys take a road trip to Carolina as America's number one pregame show broadcasts live from Charlotte. Then, the drive to the playoffs kicks into high gear. Eli Manning and Tiki Barber power the Giants into a crucial showdown with Steve Smith and the Panthers. Live from Carolina, it's the fourth Fox NFL Sunday pregame show next week in HD.
We're challenging Honda and Toyota head-on at the Hyundai Challenge Year-End Sales Event. Only Hyundai has a lineup that gives you better fuel efficiency, a better warranty, and better year-end savings on models like the award-winning Sonata. And right now you can lease a 2007 Sonata for just $199 a month. That's just $199 a month for the stylish Hyundai Sonata. We're up to the challenge. You have to hurry. Lease a new Hyundai Sonata for just $199 a month at your local Hyundai dealer.
I was always kind of big. My old pictures, I was pretty big. My parents started to get worried. It's changed a lot now. My doctor's been helping, my school's been helping. I'm not afraid to try on clothes anymore. I love my team picture. I'm not big in it. It's awesome.
Heading off health problems before they begin can have other remarkable side effects. A helping hand in the places we call home. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield.
Giant Eagle is dropping prices again, this time on qualifying generic prescription drugs at Giant Eagle Pharmacy. Now get prescriptions for only $4 each every day when you enroll in the Giant Eagle Pharmacy Rewards Program, which covers over 300 select medications at commonly prescribed dosages, up to a 30-day supply. Plus, Giant Eagle Pharmacy will match competitors' prices on any prescription. Giant Eagle Pharmacy, lowering the price of keeping your family healthy every day.
At Dick's Sporting Goods,
we've got Columbia to fit your family from head to toe.
Jackets and fleece.
Winter boots. Clothing and more. All from Columbia Sportswear. Tested tough.
Every holiday season starts at Dick's.
The North Face believes you should never stop exploring. And the place to start is Dick's Sporting Goods.
Featuring the North Face jackets.
A great selection of fleece.
Boots and more.
Every holiday season starts at Dick's.
Part of the Classic Comedies weeknight.
The Visa Halftime Report is sponsored by Visa, proud sponsor of the NFL. Life takes Visa.
here at the Meadowlands for the Visa Halftime Report. Kurt Menefee, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy. And for those of you watching, the Pittsburgh Steelers take a 10-0 lead right now at halftime. Let us get you caught up on what else is going on here in Week 13 as the Giants and Cowboys going at it right behind us. They're just going to the break. Cowboys up by 3. The Jaguars with a 10-point lead over the Dolphins in Miami. The Raiders trying to win another one for Howie, up by a touchdown at halftime. Finals. The Chicago Bears clinch the NFC North with a 10-point win. The Jets go to 7-5, blowing out the Packers in Green Bay. A late touchdown by Corey Dillon gave New England the win over the Lions. New Orleans got 4 touchdowns from Reggie Bush to handle the 49ers. Atlanta snapped its 4-game losing streak in Washington. The Arizona Cardinals have now won 2 of their last 3. Edgerrin James, 100 yards rushing in that game for the first time this season. Rob Baronis with a 60-yard field goal in the closing seconds, and the Tennessee Titans upset Indianapolis. Meanwhile, San Diego just keeps on rolling. 2 more touchdowns for LaDainian Tomlinson, and the Cleveland Browns in overtime with a 33-yard field goal by Phil Dawson knocks off the Kansas City Chiefs. All right, you look at Pittsburgh right now, rookie quarterback from Tampa Bay, really not much chance.
Well, Gronkowski, the thing about it, just like a lot of young quarterbacks, you know, he's so protective of the ball. He's not, doesn't want to have the interceptions. He's only got 7 interceptions for the year. He's holding the ball a little bit long, 4 sacks today, 17 prior to today. Then on top of that, a lot of his passes are going to the backs and the running backs and the fullbacks. He's not going down the field, but he'll develop in time.
Yeah, Pittsburgh bouncing back a little bit, particularly after being mauled. Ben Roethlisberger's been under siege and throwing the ball up as he did early in the game. Their defense is playing well right now.
All right, keep in mind, once we are done with our NFL coverage today, it's college football taking center stage here on Fox with the BCS Selection Show. It begins right about 7:50 Eastern time, 4:50 Pacific. We'll tell you who's going where, including in the national championship game. Second half coming your way from Pittsburgh right after this.
Visa, proud sponsor of the NFL.
There's only one show that honors the artist you've made number one.
Are you ready for this?
The Billboard Music Awards, live from Vegas, Fox Tomorrow, with performances by Fergie, The Killers, Gwen Stefani, Luda.
Okay, Owen Wilson, Matt Dillon, Michael Douglas. Oh, yeah.
In this wacky comedy, he proves that 3 really is a crowd. Watch as the house guest from hell overstays his welcome, and you, me, and Dupree.
My little Duprees!
You, Me, and Dupree is available right here, right now, on demand.
The number 2 ranked Panthers and Big East Player of the Year candidate Aaron Gray are looking to go a perfect 8-0. It's Pittsburgh and Auburn on CSS. From Beard Eve Memorial Coliseum on the campus of Auburn University, we're set for college basketball. Hello, everyone. I'm Paul Ellen, set to bring you the play-by-play this afternoon as the Pittsburgh Panthers. Smith and Sonny, this is a welcome. Big-time player.
Well, he's improved every year. He's lost weight. He can step away from the basket 12 feet and knock down shots. He's a great shooter. His inside presence makes him a better player. He's capable of a double-double every night.
And for the Auburn Tigers, the biggest signee of the Jeff Lebo era so far has been Corvotny Barber. He's a sophomore now.
Die-hard drinkers, and they put their hearts.
No word on what caused the crash. The victims' names are not being released. Moon Township police are still searching for a missing man. 23-year-old Ryan Booty was last seen at Images Bar on Liberty Avenue Thanksgiving Eve. Police say Ryan was driving a teal 1995 Ford Mustang. If you have any information, you're asked to call Moon Township police. A Cecil Township church is looking to fix its water woes. Officials say a break happened yesterday at St. Mary's Cecil Church. Sunday services went on as usual, but CCD classes were canceled for today. The water service to the building has been turned off. No word on what caused the break. The weather returning a bit closer to normal today. Meteorologist Kevin Benson has your forecast from Severe Weather Center 11.
Digital Doppler.
A little
I think they needed him to be more of an option in the low post, and he has been a factor in the paint so far in this game.
He's the ACC's leading rebounder with 10 a game. He's got 5 points tonight. The jumper for Peacock. The freshman out of Miami, Florida, Norland High School's got 40 family members watching him tonight.
Bit of a surprise, I think, starting coming into the year. I think people thought that Rashawn Dickey would get that call, but Peacock has really gotten the attention of Coach Paul Hewitt. He loves what he brings to the table.
Clinton, tough baseline jumper, halfway down, rolls out. Georgia Tech looking to tie, maybe even take the lead. Young inside, Jeremy Smith has Graham on him, count the basket, and he'll go to the line. That'll be two on Graham.
And that was a great seal by Jeremy Smith down low. He got Graham on his back right underneath the rim, and this is going to result in either 2 points or 3 points. You get a player on your back like that, Graham has to fight over just a little bit too late, and that allowed Smith to make the catch.
Raymond Hicks, number 42, Dwayne Collins, number 21, have checked into the lineup for Miami. Jeremy Smith averaging just under 11 a game.
Understands. That's why we guarantee accident repairs in writing when your car's fixed at a certified Blue Ribbon repair shop. So switch to us. See what life's like with a guarantee.
Nationwide is on your side.
It's that magical time of year. Get a special lease offer on an E350 sports sedan with over $2,500 worth of new standard features at the Mercedes-Benz Winter Event now through January 2nd. There's never been a better time to get that Mercedes-Benz on your wish list.
Introducing Chase Freedom. It feels like no other credit card in the world. And it works like no other card, too. Feel free to choose cash back. And then change to points. And then change again, all with the same card and without losing a thing. That's freedom. Chase Freedom. Get it free at chase.com/freedom.
No matter where you're going, no matter who you're with, no matter where the party is, stop at McDonald's on the way. Right now, get 20 Chicken McNuggets for only $3.99. Just $3.99 for 20 all-white meat Chicken McNuggets.
Watch Channel 11 News on Fox 53.
Picture this. It starts out with a whistle.
Scene open.
You're in outer spaceships.
I have a donkey and the elephant.
Don Cheadle.
Don Cheadle.
Hey-ya-dum-da.
Nobody knows what it means.
He's got the pom-poms going.
And they're shaking their behinds with excitement.
Touchdown.
He scores.
I'm the greatest.
All of a sudden, a killer whale just jumps right over the whole surf.
Oh!
And that's my pitch.
Pitch us your idea for the best NFL Super Bowl commercial ever.
Seriously?
Register now.
Buccaneers head coach John Gruden.
Coach Gruden, coming into this game, you knew the defense was going to be a
putt the ball rather than having to chip it, Roger.
Well, I don't think there's any question they would have had to putt through an expansive fringe that it might have been as much as 12 feet. Now it's not as big an issue. Should move right as it gets onto the green, going across a knob, then straighten up. Speed, the big issue here. It needs to settle down a little bit.
Dad, can you come through again, please? He's leaned on Bernhard a lot today.
Well, the important thing, though, there, he hit a good putt from the standpoint the line was good. Yes, the speed was a little harder than it needed to be.
Zone blitz defense, Dick LeBeau.
Absolutely, and there's a lot of pressure on him right now to try to make plays downfield, and Dick LeBeau's defense is notorious for putting pressure on quarterbacks, and he's struggled with that so far a little bit in this first half.
Meanwhile, you look at the first half numbers and what's gone on there, it's been about pressure, and getting pressure on the opposing quarterbacks. And the team that can do that first has had success. Pittsburgh did that first.
Absolutely. They really swarmed Gradkowski all first half. They came from all different types of places. They weren't able to let him to set up in the pocket and throw the football downfield. He's been forced to try to throw checkdowns and just hold on. He hasn't had a lot of time, and a lot of that is because of Dick LeBeau's 3-4 style defense. I think what's interesting, what we heard John Gruden say about he's got to see things better. I think for young quarterbacks, when they get sacked a few times early in the game, their eyes come down from the secondary. They're not so much looking at guys running routes, getting open. They check to see who's around them and who's rushing them. Mm-hmm. I think that's what he's talking about when he says he's got to see things better. He's got to keep his eyes downfield, and he's got to try to do his best job at finding his open receivers.
And under Bill Cowher, the Steelers are 113-13-1 when leading at the half. So